the heart of a champion. What does it take to really, truly be a champion? Well, it takes more than excuses. It takes more than just giving yourself a pass. There are only so many champions in the world. And true champions understand what dedication and hard work really is. True champions understand if you're gonna be a lion, you got to know what it means to go through the jungle. You can't pretend or fake it just to make it.
The name Nelly, Nelly.
Go tell a friend to tell a friend. I'ma keep the same brain whether I lose or win. Up or down 10, I'ma fight to the end. Let's go.
Ain't no way they can stop me now. Get it, cause I'm on my way. I can feel my ring coming. It's the blood of a champion. Bumping deep inside my veins. Too much pride to be running. I'ma get what I can and more. Even if my blood, my sweat, and my tears don't mean nothing. It's the heart of a champion.
It's the heart of a
Welcome in, everybody, to the TBL. We are returning. We are live here at our new home for the Vancouver Volcanoes, Hudson's Bay High School. We have the 23rd meeting of the Vancouver Volcanoes versus the Salem Capitals. We just came up with a victory the other night. Hopefully, we can continue this run coming in tonight. James, how you feeling, my friend?
I'm feeling great. We're watching fans still filtering in here to the Hudson Bay High School gymnasium. And as they're filling in, they're looking for these two teams to fill up the point totals again tonight here as they combine, the two teams combine for 253 points and 170 field goals on Friday night.
Yep. And let's go to our Vancouver lineups right here. Here's our starting five here. We got the man in the middle, Tayshaun Pickett, Xavier Dupree, and Elijah Boogie Ford playing the fours, and then Marcus Golder and Rashawn Coleman to balance out the starting five.
Sean Coleman really came in big for those two teams.
And for the Salem Capitals, we got the big man in the middle, Mo Smith, and then we got at forward Domo Lawrence and Isaiah Gentry with the backcourt of Allen Billinger Jr. and Preston Whitfield. Keys to the game here. Do you want to go into the keys here, James?
Absolutely. As we saw there in the fourth quarter, feed Pickett. You know, get him some points. Keep pounding into Pickett inside. The Salem Capitals had no answer for him on Friday night. A strong third quarter would be a big help as they've played the Vancouver Volcanoes have played a style of basketball that have had to make big fourth quarter comebacks.
Yep, and we got to keep them off the free throw line. They did really well in the last game. And also, you know, it's just continue to build that confidence. If we can come off, this is the biggest weekend for opening weekend here. If we can come out the win after beating Seattle and possibly two here at Salem, that would be huge for this franchise. We've never started off as a 4-0 start here.
As you know, repeat business is where a lot of businesses thrive, especially at the local level like we are here. And like I said, nothing would be better to get two wins against a team like this on the same weekend.
Yeah, and Domo, it's great to see him out there, had that scary injury the other night. He's wearing the protective mask out there. The guy is a warrior on and off the court. I expect him to play with so much emotion like he always does tonight.
Yeah, him limiting to only 5 points against the Volcanoes on Friday night, that's something that could be a big boost to the Capitals if they can make up that 11-point difference.
Absolutely. A couple players to watch tonight. You know, on our side, I would look at, you know, Tayshaun Pickett, of course. And then on the other side, Isaiah Gentry had a great debut for them the other night. He had 25 points for them. He's always been solid. He had 5 boards as well. And this should be another tight matchup. There's a great look at head coach Kevin Johnson right there. This matchup, you know, it's a little lopsided on paper with Salem having 16 of the 22 matchups coming out on top. But this is a whole different Volcano squad this season. And I don't know, I think we're going to come out another one. We'll see how it goes.
Good chance to start the season off 4-0.
Here's the tip. Billinger brings it up here. Rashawn Coleman matched up on him. Here comes the screen by Mo Smith. Mo wide open. You can't leave him open there. Good board there by Coleman. Coleman usually likes to push tempo. This time he's slowing it down a little bit, trying to get a feel of the new home court here. Let's see what we got dialed up. Golder gets it down. Here goes the big man. Feed him more. Tayshaun. Oh. Little off there. Good defense. Good rebound by Mo Smith.
Yeah, we're starting off even on the rebounding. It was a big edge for the Volcanoes on Friday night, 50-38.
Great point there. Preston going to work here. Going to Mook. On Boogie. Good spin by Preston. Bounces to Golder. Golder pushes it up. Here goes Coleman. Right on Whitfield. He slows it down. Looks over to X. X from deep. Misses. There's Gentry with the board there.
Dupree had a really good even game. Had a big shot there in the fourth quarter to get the momentum back on the Volcano side.
Absolutely. Domo right here. Domo pulls up. Domo from deep, just like you talked about in the pregame. He had that 5 points. A lot of it was from the injury and lack of minutes. But Domo in the opener had 22 for them. So. Yeah.
And he might be feeling a little bit extra wearing that mask. You know, it might give him a little extra boost in this game, thinking that, you know, he can get back into the flow like he missed out on Friday.
Absolutely. Oh, there goes Pickett again. Let's see what kind of D they do on him. There he is. He's just a little off. You know, they're doing a good job there, standing their ground there. Mo Smith, he's definitely a scrappy defender.
Yeah, good help defense there for the Salem Capitals. But good opportunities for Pickett on both possessions.
Yep, there goes Billinger from deep. Quick start here. Three again. Quick 6-0 run for the Capitals. If you're a Capitals fan, you definitely like what you're seeing here for them.
And they had 16 three-pointers on Friday night, and it's all started. We're already starting in that trend here today.
Starts with the Capital Five. I've been talking about it last game.
Yep.
Oh, good help there. Good foul. Foul on Billinger. Looks like Boogie's going to go to the line for two.
And that's part of that feeding Pickett early on, getting the ball in his hands. Not only do they get it down low on the low block, but they can also reverse that to try to get it into Dupree and Ford in the middle as well, who contributed really greatly to that win on Friday night for the Volcanoes.
Absolutely. A little bit about Boogie Ford. So far in the season, he's averaging 9.7, 7 boards, shooting it 83% from the line. He's from Newark, New Jersey, and there as a senior, he averaged 24 points a game in high school. He spent some time at Barton Community College. He led the sophomore Cougars to a Region 6 semifinals, averaging 17 points a game with a 26-8 record.
Well, and he had 10 points on Friday night, one of 6 Volcanoes to have double-digit scoring.
Yeah, and both of them didn't fall there. We got to make sure we're knocking down our free throws because the Capitals, that's one of mine there, is they'll knock theirs down. There's one of the Capital Five, just missed there. Gentry goes right over to Dupree. Dupree pushing it up. Over to Golder. Golder step back, three. There's Pickett with the board. There it is. There's that first bucket. Tayshaun Pickett.
And that's what you want to see from Pickett, not being afraid to get it down there and get it back up on, get it back into the hole.
Yeah, Boogie just got called for a foul there. He was trying to set up for take the charge there, but it was a smart veteran play there by the Capitals there. Inbounded to Billinger. Billinger deep. A little short on it, right to Pickett. I think you know, too, both these teams, they're going to try to get a feel of this gym, so it might start off a little bit sloppy, a little bit slow with these shots. But I figure, you know, once the game goes on, they'll get more comfortable. There's X. It's a little off, right to Allen Billinger. Billinger pushes up. There's Gentry. Good help there on D. Wide open, Billinger. There it is. Allen Billinger again for three. That's already three threes for the Capitals early in this game.
Yeah, and that's a form of that transition, even, you know, on that trailing player getting that three, that wide open look.
Yeah, they're so far early in this game, 9-2, 8 minutes, 38 seconds left to go. Coleman going to work. Preston uses ground behind the back. Pickett, there's a mismatch there. Misses. There's Dupree. Good tip there right before the shot clock violation. Xavier Dupree on the board there, 9-4.
Really great aggressive play there for the Volcanoes in that area of the court.
Yes. Here's Gentry. Gentry holding it, standing his ground there. Domo deep again. Up, off the foot there. Ooh, I thought maybe it was off Mo. Looks like they called it on Pickett there. Pickett there talking with Smith a little bit. Billinger inbounds to Gentry. Kicks back Preston, pump fake. Ooh, they call a late foul. Yeah, looks like they did. Let's see what the call is.
You know, and that was really key for the third quarter for the Capitals to get the Volcanoes into foul trouble and to get to the line as often as they did.
Yes, yeah, it was. Looks like we got an early timeout here for the Vancouver Volcanoes. 9-4, Salem Capitals with the lead with 7 minutes, 57 seconds left to go. We're going to take another quick profile look on the players to watch tonight. Here's a good look at our guys right here, Tayshaun Pickett and Isaiah Gentry. There's our averages so far on the season early. 16.7, 8.7 rebounds, 2.3 assists for Pickett, 25 for Gentry, 5 rebounds, 2 assists.
Yeah, 25 points for Gentry on Friday night. Pickett came back with a 19-point effort himself.
Yep. It's interesting to see what kind of discussion they're having there in the huddle. Vancouver definitely doesn't like what they're seeing so far, but again, it's just getting used to this gym. We'll see what kind of adjustments they make. And if on the Salem side, you want to continue to, if you're going to get those wide open looks for threes, they're going to make us pay.
Well, and it also causes you to adjust what you're doing on the defensive side, and that's something that a team will always want to force the other team to make mistakes doing something that they didn't prepare for, adjusted that much.
Yeah, and then talk about some of the keys, you know, you were thinking about, too, going into this game, that what you saw.
Yeah, I mean, I just see it's like maybe this is a good opportunity to get to 4-0, to be the first team in the Pacific Northwest our league to get to 4 wins, and they're only right now a half game ahead of the Seattle Superhawks, so to maintain that lead in the division early in the season.
Yeah, I've been talking about pregame, too. Like, this is arguably the biggest weekend for the Volcanoes up until probably like the end of the season towards playoff time, because you get a three-game stretch where you play a team like the Seattle Superhawks, a team that has, you know, before this season had every victory. We had not beaten them yet. To get that win, and then with Salem having the series lead on us as well, getting that win on Friday, that's another huge step. And if somehow we can close that out this weekend, that'd be the perfect weekend to put us in the driver's seat early in the Pacific Northwest Division.
As you were talking about eruptions during the last game, here it's like, let's keep that lava flowing. Let's keep that momentum going early in the season. Especially the Superhawks are not letting up. They've managed to get big wins so far this season. They've only had the one loss that the Volcanoes gave them.
Yeah, good call there. And then Preston Whitfield, a little shout out there. You know, Preston spent some time with us with the Volcanoes in Tijuana in the summer league. And, man, he did not want to put on that Volcano jersey. I got some nice pics of him at home, so I had to give him a little bit of a hard time about that. So, looks like Coleman bringing it up here. Here he goes, the crossover. Good D by Preston, though. Good strength by Coleman. They're battling. Coleman gets it. Coleman with the bucket. Beautiful put back there by Rashawn Coleman to put him with his first bucket on the night. There he is again. There's the aggressiveness. Mo Smith, open look, right to Boogie. Boogie pushes. Good spin on Gentry, kicks it out to Golder. Golder, good look there by Dupree. Beautiful play there by Dupree to Boogie Ford. They called delay a game? Oh, they did. Boogie just got a little bit too excited there. He's boogieing down after that one.
I mean, hard not to. You like seeing that collaborative play there between Dupree and Ford. You know, passing up that jump shot and getting an easy look down under the basket.
Yeah, it was a smart, it's an easy two there. Oh, tipped it away there. The three would be nice, but when you can get that easy bucket down low, here's the good look of that replay right there. There it is right there. Beautiful finish there by Ford. But, yeah, you can't touch the ball after you score the back basket. They will call those delay of games.
Just didn't bounce our way on that one. And hopefully that doesn't lead to any more of those technicals that we saw there in the third quarter in the last game between these two teams, which really allowed the Capitals to swing the game in their favor before the Volcanoes eventually did take control.
Yeah, good spin there by Domo. Like, again, it's great to see him out there having a good start there, especially if you're a Capitals fan, and me, a personal fan of his. It's good to see that. Good crossover by Coleman. Ah, wide open X. Ooh, we got to knock those down. Good board there by Moe. He had good positioning there. The box out on Pickett. Ah, Coleman. Got to move your feet there. He went in for the reach there. That's a veteran play by Whitfield. And they're jowling right now.
Yeah, that's going to be an interesting matchup all game long to see if they can keep that intensity in there, but also, you know, they can limit it with the fouls.
Yeah, we can't put them in the bonus. And there's Domo again. Speaking of Domo, he's off to a really fast start there. He's out to 7 already.
He has half the Capitals scoring so far as they built a 6-point lead.
Yeah, he's almost outscoring us by himself. Oh, there's a forced turnover. You never want to leave your feet on those passes either. Good block there by Boogie. And it's off of Gentry. Beautiful play by Boogie Ford. That's what he brings to the table, that toughness.
You know, on the offensive side, you can see they're trying to get into the hands of Marcus Golder, who did lead the team in points with 28 on Friday night. And that's a good effort, especially when you know that on the defensive end, maybe you can come back and make a play like that to get the possession back in your hands.
Yeah, here's a good replay of that right here. Here it is, the block on Gentry. Beautiful play, perfection.
Two-handed block by Boogie Ford.
Billinger pushes. Good trap there. Ooh, Pickett took a shot there. Gentry, we talked about it. Stay on your feet. Good move by Smith and to force the foul. The and one. Way to swing it around, Capitals there. Mo Smith going to try to complete the three-point play on the season. Mo, averaging 10 points so far, 4 rebounds.
And they kind of give the Volcanoes a taste of their own medicine there, getting that play down on the block instead of taking the jump shot.
Marky Adams checking in for the first time tonight, and Devon Bolton as well for Pickett and Dupree. See if we can get a different kind of, you know, good jump, you know, some energy off the bench there.
Yeah, Adams only had 3 points in this on Friday night, but he did provide really good defense, really good rebounding, and changed a lot of shots for the Capitals.
Yes, and also Thomas Miles checking in for the first time too, our hero from Seattle. Coleman over to Bolton. It's interesting what this lineup's going to do. Good screen by Markey. Good take by Miles. And the foul. That's what we got to do. We got to get to the foul line there. I believe Domo gets the foul on that one. The score right now is 17-8. The Capitals with the early lead with 5 minutes, 28 seconds left in the first quarter. Miles to shoot 1 of 2. We're on the season. Miles is scored 16.5 so far, 3.5 rebounds, and 80% from the three-point line. Barry's the first. Number 15 here. Knocks down a pair. He still stays 100% on the season. At free throw. Bolton matched up on Billinger. Billinger goes right around. Good block there by Markey.
I mean,
and
there's
staying
Marquis
here.
Adams again, changing shots when he comes in instantly when he has to give Pickett a blow.
Yeah, Marquis was, again, he was top 10 in blocks last year in the entire TBL. So he's got a good knack to have his timing to block those shots. Good look at Coach Cal over there talking to Caleb Coleman. Devontae Cleveland over to Gentry. There's Gentry, another three there. It's the biggest lead of the night so far early. It is 20-10 right now.
First 3 points for Gentry as well.
Yep, there's Miles trying to match it. Good block out there by Gentry. Gentry with the board. Pushes the Domo over to Cleveland. Good block by Boogie. Smith misses. Tips it back to Gentry from deep. There's Bolton with the board. Way to clear it out. Devon. Devon spent time with Seattle again last year. Pushes up to Boogie. Ooh, turnover. Off his knee. Looks like we got a timeout coming here. Nope, substitution.
Yeah,
Boogie coming out for Coleman.
We're going to get Coleman to come in the game. He had 14 points on Friday, replacing Boogie Ford, who had two blocks earlier so far in this game.
Yeah, had a good talk with Caleb in pregame, and he's got a really nice fadeaway shot. He's really good with his feet. Good pass there. Speaking of that, Billinger completes the play. Good pass by Gentry. This lead is built up to 12 now. Great start for the Capitals. 22-10 right now.
Just not a lot of offensive going right for the Volcanoes, but still an opportunity to get that right and get the flow back in their game in their favor.
Yeah. Bolton with the screen just a little off. We got Domo took another shot there. Hopefully he's okay.
Also looked like he was adjusting his mask.
That could be it too as well. And there's Billinger, one of the Capital Five. This is now a 15-point lead and getting a little bit out of a hand early, and it's a great timeout here for the Volcanoes, and definitely need to make some adjustments here and make maybe a couple substitutions as well. We'll see what happens.
They have to find the right mix out there, and then more importantly, cut down on that perimeter scoring.
Yep. And we want to do a little shout out here to the East Vancouver Business Association. They're a strong leader for Southeast Clark County in East Vancouver that provides a platform for businesses to express their interest in both civic and economic development for our community. EVBA's mission is to promote and support the businesses within our community to participate in the development of our community's growth, to network within the business community, and to install cooperation and mutual support for our professional and civic goals. The Volcanoes are proud to support the EVBA Scholarship Fund and has raised over, listen to this, $190,000 already by donating half the tickets of Game 1 from ticket revenue and half of the proceeds from tonight's raffle. All of our scholarship fund money stays local and goes to kids attending schools such as WSU Vancouver and Clark College. Thank you for partnering with us alongside to host the second EVA BA Community Fundraising Game. And our host, RV Style Resorts, with 18 locations in Washington, Oregon. Let RV in Style Resorts help you find your next adventure. And let's see, we want to thank also State Farm, Chris Green also. They're a great help as well. They support us as well. If you want to look out to them, reach their office.
Yeah, check them out at chrisinsureme.com for more info. Thank you to Chris Green for sponsoring Vancouver Volcanoes basketball.
And so we're getting ready to come back here. We're also going to talk about Waste Connections.
We would like to thank Waste Connections for being the Volcanoes' official community partner and helping fundraise for our local partners. Waste Connections, connect with the future.
All right, we are returned here early in the first quarter where the Capitals have an early 15-point lead with 3 minutes 53 seconds. Coach Cal cannot be liking what he sees. Made a couple adjustments. Here comes Courtney Anderson in here.
Still plenty of Courtney Anderson getting his first action there that I've seen him play. He was didn't get a chance to get into Friday's game.
Gentry with the ball here. Kicks it over to Cleveland. Cleveland matched up with Bolton, takes it inside, right off the knee of looks like it was off the knee of Anderson, but they called it off Gentry. Volcano ball.
I mean, it would be interesting to see if this game takes a little bit of a turn from Friday night's game, and then it's the Vancouver Volcanoes who need to come back and put the pressure back on the Salem Capitals to get the lead turned around.
Absolutely. This is a great new camera angle that Bobby P Media brought to us this year. And Miles just hits the big one there. We needed that one. Volcanoes just cut the lead to 12 right now. It's 13-25. Cleveland to Domo. Domo over to Gentry. Back down to Domo. That's a rough matchup there for Courtney. Mo Smith from deep. Misses. Miles has got it. Miles is pushing. Matched up there with Gentry. Markey getting ready to come up for that screen. There it is. Over to Coleman. Bolton. Back to Coleman. Coleman from deep. Misses up. Domo with the board. No rebounders down there ready to rebound.
I mean, they really still want to get that ball under the little block and take advantage of that mismatch they have with Adams on the
court. Yeah, I'd like to see a couple post moves for Markey down there and let him go to work there. Good finish there by Cleveland to build this lead back up 27-13. Miles, good crossover. Good take for Miles to draw the foul on, I believe, Gentry. Was that Gentry or Cleveland?
See, it looked like Gentry.
Two free throws here for Miles. Miles again from Portland, Oregon. On the season, again, he's averaging 16.5 in this early on in this season.
Leading the Volcanoes tonight with 5 as he goes to the line for 2.
And he buries the first. Substitution right now. Here comes Jameel Tolbert for the first time and the veteran, Paul Hafford, the ex-Volcano. Paul had a really nice showing the other night, including 11 from 11 from the free throw line, the charity stripe. He's definitely one guy we don't want to put at the foul line. Buries them both there. Miles. We got to make these free throws count every opportunity we get there. Billinger, that's his shot there, and he misses. Rebounded by Coleman. 27-15 right now, just under 2 minutes in the first quarter. Courtney misses in and out. There's Mo Smith. You know, the Capitals are doing a really good job staying down there, being ready to rebound after every shot we're shooting. So we're having a difficult time getting any opportunities for second chance points.
Yeah, it's definitely a turn from Friday night where they're the ones now leading in the rebound category, 14-11.
Yeah, they've made some really good adjustments there. Any stats stick out for you here at all, James?
That was a big one there. Like I said, we've had Harris coming back into the forefront of scoring as he did against the Seattle Superhawks, but they really need to get more from getting the ball in down into the backcourt.
Down to the post, yeah.
Yeah, down to the post. They got to take more advantage of that, especially since it has been such a focus on the offensive end for them.
Absolutely. Looks like it's staying here on the Volcano side. Good look there at Mo Smith and Caleb Coleman. Bolton to inbound. Over to Miles. Miles from deep. Ooh.
Good rebound with Coleman.
There it is. That's his move there. Misses. Way to crash the boards. Off the knee. Ooh. You know, I like the hustle there for Coleman there. You know, we definitely need those second chance opportunities.
Yeah, Coleman was a big contributor on Friday night. 14 points. It was 4 from 6 from the free throw line. But contributed all of the 3 rebounds, 2 blocks. He's given them good minutes so far.
Hafford going to work. He's matched up on Bolton. Good move there. Up, rebounded by Miles. Miles pushing. Over to Courtney Anderson. Back to Bolton. Bolton from deep. Devon Bolton. Huge three there. That's what Devon does. In his career, he's averaged over 40% from that three-point line. And that's what he is. He's a sharpshooter. That's what he mainly brings to the table. He can do a little bit of more, but that three-point spot, that's all him.
Anderson will pick the pocket right there.
Good spin by Smith. Good help from deep. Tolbert misses. There's Bolton with the tip to his teammate, Coleman. I like what I'm seeing so far at Devon here.
Yeah, he could have been the spark that they needed, given a little different rhythm back in the backcourt with Anderson as well.
Yep, he's matched up with Hafford. Good screen by Markey. Holds his dribble. Oh, tough pass. Way to take it. Tolbert, good block. Coleman, so at the end of the first quarter here from Hudson's Bay High School. The Salem Capitals have the early lead, 27 to your Vancouver Volcanoes, 18.
But they had the lead at 15 at one point. So now, except they cut it back to 9 to go to 27 to 18.
Yes, they did. We're going to go to his highlights from last game.
We'll see some of those volcanic eruptions that you were talking about going into yesterday's game as they came through, especially as that third quarter and fourth quarter progressed. They really got the crowd into it.
Yeah, yes, they did. Here they go right here. Here's huddling in here. Look at Coleman. The Golder here. Golder had a big night. As he's brought up earlier, Pickett as well.
Pickett had 19.
Golder going to work again.
And really in that fourth quarter, no answer for Pickett from the Capitals.
And Boogie had the big steal down the stretch there.
Yeah, and he always pushed the action, drawing fouls, getting the ball over to his teammates as well.
Yeah, that's a tough when he gets that deep down there.
Yeah, 7 points in a row there in the fourth quarter for Pickett. Really turned the game back into the favor for the Volcanoes.
Xavier Dupree had a big night. Rashawn Coleman was player of the game. Had a 24 on the night. Had his season high.
Yeah, Dupree, 11 points, 12 points, 11 boards.
Good look at Chuck Jones there with the beautiful stroke there. Miles.
Yeah, Thomas Miles, 11 points again. One of six players for the Vancouver Volcanoes to score in double figures against the Capitals.
There, Dupree, beautiful stock. There's that patented jump shot there by Coleman.
Yeah, turnaround jumper right at the elbow for Coleman.
And there's that steal I was talking about by Boogie that just iced it right at the end. The big Showtime dunk.
Fire and everybody really that really felt like it aced the game for them at that point when they got that big transition done.
There's your highlights from last evening. So James, what do you think that both teams are talking about on the bench right now about adjustments here?
Well, the Capitals have to like what they saw in the first quarter, especially in the perimeter, and they want to see if can they take advantage of that. They know an adjustment's going to come there. Can they get the ball inside, maybe do a Domo and try and get some more points. For the Volcanoes, it's really just about finding the right mix, clamping down on that perimeter shooting, not giving so many easy looks to the Capitals, but also trying to maintain what they're doing on offense, feeding it on inside and converting when they do get that opportunity.
Yeah. And it looks like we got a couple substitutions in here. There's Tyreek Price in for the first time, number one for the Capitals, and also Saul Matacor. He missed last game. He was a little bit under the weather. There's Miles with the miss.
Yeah, highly contested by Price in the game now.
Matacor pushes up. There's Tolbert wide open. Good board for Miles there. Thomas Miles over to Anderson. Anderson wide open. That's the look we want. Bolton got to knock that one down. When Bolton usually gets those looks, it's very rare that he misses those. There goes Cleveland again, goes right at him. Ooh, they did call the block. Potential and one here for Devontae Cleveland.
Yeah, Cleveland, that'll put him at 4 points for this game, looking to make it five.
Yeah, Miles was called for the foul there. Cleveland in on the season, early on he's averaging 8.5 points. He's a veteran, he played for this roster last year. Two rebounds, 2.5 assists as well. And again, this team just shoots the ball very well at the free throw line. One of the best in the entire TBL as well.
Yeah, it drains that one. They get back up to a 12-point lead for the Capitals.
Good crossover by Miles. Kicks it back out to Anderson. Anderson didn't get much time on the last one, so it's great to see him out here. Here he goes to work. Over to Bolton. Oh, shot clock violation. Good defense. We stalled a little bit there on that possession there. So great job for Salem to stand pat there, make us make the move.
Yeah, we got Pickett back on the court now for the Volcanoes. That could be something that maybe helps them break that little ice on the offensive end and get those front court shots and get them early and try to make the Capitals work to defend it.
Yep. Also checking in first time tonight, number 24, Chuck Jones, making his first entrance tonight. Tolbert up. Good turnover there. Brings it right back to us. There's a good look, Chuck.
Got Capitals a little out of sync on that play, trying to get the cutter in to drive in there.
I expect, like you said, I expect them to try to get it into Pickett. There's a good look at Coach Cal. He's definitely not happy so far at what he's seeing, but there's a lot of game left to be played.
Yeah, as we found in the last two games, it's like the game can turn, and it can turn here in the second quarter. Now, you don't have to wait till the third quarter.
That's right. Here goes Jones. Back to Miles, deep. Misses. Got to get that board, though. Price with the board. Up to Matacor. Back to Hafford, deep. There's one of the Capital Five, the veteran, Paul Hafford.
First 3 points from Hafford in this game.
Yeah, the last thing we want to do is get him going.
Back to the largest lead of the night for the Capitals.
Boogie Ford going to work. Cleveland, he's tough. Right on Cleveland. And it's just not quite falling. Matacor gets the board there.
Just not a friend in the rim, but really good to see Ford pushing his way into that scoring opportunity.
Let's see what we got here. Blocking foul. There's Hafford's three. A good look at that. Swish money.
Yeah, I mean, you can see. He seems to really give them a lot of confidence when he's on the court.
Yeah, Hafford, you know, he's very deceiving when you look at his three-point percentage this season. It's very low because he really struggled in that first one against Seattle. So he's up to 21% from three-point, but I almost guarantee before the end of the season he's going to be shooting around 40-plus. Good look at Tayshaun there. Tayshaun, Pickett.
Yep. Yeah, we got Tayshaun, Ford, Anderson, Miles on the court now for
Kevin Johnson there. Looking styling as always. There's Tolbert. Doesn't get the roll. Miles with another rebound. Up. Another foul here. Is it that on Tolbert? They call both? Yeah, it looks like they called double fouls there. You know, Pickett's had a rough beginning with his fouls in the beginning of the season. He's up there in the top of the league with averaging almost five fouls a game.
And you're going to have that with a little bit of that with his style of play.
Yeah.
It just matters to keep him on the court as much as possible and take care of that dynamic that he gives you that you're not going to see a lot.
Yeah. We need him to be successful. And there it is. Pickett gets that bucket. Talking to Coach West a little bit before pregame as well. Pickett is coming in a little bit banged up. You know, he's taking a big pounding. You know, this is game three in 4 days. Here comes Coleman back in the game for Anderson. Anderson brought in some good minutes there. It's great to see him. Good look with him and Coach Cal talking.
Yeah, getting some word of encouragement and really maybe trying to set up his next entry into the game and trying to see what he's seeing out there on the court. Yep.
Tayshaun on the season. Again, he averages 16.7 points a game. And shoots it very well at the free throw line. Completes the three-point play, 85.7% at the line. So the lead right now, 33-21, Capitals with 9 minutes, 20 seconds left early in this second quarter. Price bringing it up. Price from deep. Misses. Price had a rough night the other night, went 0-for-6. Hafford again. Oh, barely out. There's Tolbert. See, those second chance points, we have to box out. Price, another three. And he's going to hit it, you know. Price is another really good streaky shooter. That's why he's also included in that Capital Five. And now it's up to 36-21. Timeout here. 9 minutes on the dot.
Yeah, going out of that first quarter, the Volcanoes got it down under double digits, having a hard time maintaining that. And again, we're going to hear from another one of our great sponsors. We would like to thank Waste Connections for being the official Volcanoes community partner and helping fundraise for our local partners. Waste Connections, connect with the future.
And pop local. Local vendors, local products, servicing local customers. Check out Pop Local on Vancouver's waterfront and tell them that Vancouver Volcanoes sent you. And by Yoder Chiropractic, the Vancouver Volcanoes official chiropractor. There's a great look at him right there, doing some work. Serves the entire Volcano organization and is the right place to start your journey to better living. Get started with Vancouver's premier chiropractic and massage center today at Yoder Chiropractic.
Yoder totally took a full body approach.
We provide care for.
All right, we return here. They're talking in the huddles, you know, continuous adjustments. You know, you can't leave those 3-point shooters open, you know, and those second chance points, they got a couple opportunities on that possession alone. And when you're getting the Capital Five, any open looks, eventually they're going to kill you.
Yeah, and we're now at the five different players for the Capitals have 3-point makes here so far in the first half. And it's really hard to see where they can limit those opportunities when so many shot makers are on their side.
Yeah, it's routine. They've been doing that for, you know, a couple seasons now in a row, and everybody knows it's going to continue to kill you unless you at least keep a hand in their face.
And also block out.
Exercise consulting, massage therapy.
I had neck pain, I had back pain, I was low on energy. I came in and Dr. Yoder totally took a full body approach. He was able to give me healing in my neck, my back, I have more energy. They just educated me and I love this place, they're wonderful.
My philosophy is to get to the root of the problem and not just the overlying pain. So we want to really figure out what the one thing.
All right, we're back. Coleman pushing it up here. Price picking him up deep in the backcourt. Let's see what we do here. Kicks it to Boogie. Good play by Tolbert to read that.
Yeah, Tolbert defended, pick it really well.
And with a post player too, you don't want to normally do bounce passes with him. You want to throw, you know, a little bit higher up there, especially with a guy at Pickett's size there. So he's just ready to go to work right when you get him the ball.
I mean, that shows it's just been a really good effort from the Capitals to defend what we pretty much knew what the Volcanoes wanted to do, and they've defended it well.
Yep, Tyreek Price making his first attempts at the free throw line this season. And Tyreek, you know, we talked a little bit about it last game. Tyreek's one of those players that I fully believe he reminds you a lot of Alan Billinger when Billinger backed up Alford. He's one of those players, you put him on almost any other team, he can go in and be your starter right away and put up big minutes and big points.
Yeah, it really shows the kind of depth the Capitals have.
Absolutely. Swings it over to Boogie. Boogie for three.
You know,
right,
the Rens just not being friendly to the Volcanoes so far in the first half. That's something they can do. They can maybe turn around, and that shows that we still have a chance here to get back in this game.
Oh, absolutely. There's plenty of time for that. And, yeah, they're just barely not falling. There's Hafford again from deep. Good defense by Miles, though, to challenge that. That's what you need. Boogie with the board, the boogie board. There's the spin. Good pass to Miles in the corner. See, we got to make him pay when we get those. Good hustle by Chuck Jones. Keep it alive.
Chuck Jones pulls down the rebound and then draws the foul as well.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the thing. You know, when we get those great passes like that and we have our wide-open three-point shooters, we have to knock those down, especially to get back in this game. Or, like you said, it potentially could get out of hand if we're not knocking them down. Inbounded to Coleman. Let's see what we dial up here. They're anticipating Pickett. Good look. There's the beautiful pass by Pickett.
Really good motion. That's how you take advantage of them focusing so much on Pickett to get those points. Chuck Jones with his first two.
Beautiful back, that beautiful bucket there. Miles up, there's a miss. There's Boogie with the board. Boogie up to Coleman. There's the Pickett. Oh, they called the charge. Nope, they got the block on Price. Whew, that was close.
Yeah, Price wasn't set. Really good to push that, you know, really good on Pickett to be involved in that transition.
Oh, no. Yeah, that's the thing, too, when you take a charge. There's a good replay of it. There's the play for Miles on the bucket on the last possession. But Price is down. Oh, he's got up. That's great to see there. You know, injuries is my worst part of sports. I do really dislike when guys get hurt like that, especially, you know, they're so talented. They work so hard just to get to these games.
Yeah, we want to see the competition between the best that the teams can put out there, and that's how you know how you're going to do later in the season as well.
Yep. And checking back in is Preston Whitfield for the Capitals. Price at the line. Hits the first. He sure got a nice-looking stroke at the line. And Golder coming back in. Great minutes there for Thomas Miles.
Yeah, he got up to nine points for the Volcanoes to lead the team.
Yeah, he brings a lot of scoring off the bench, which is very, very valuable. Pickett completes it, knocks it down again. You know, we got to make every possession count to get right back in this lead. We got to get a couple stops, and we got to make a couple buckets, maybe force a couple turnovers here.
Well, the Capitals were at a double-digit lead on Friday night, and then, as you said, you turn it over to Pickett, and he really made the difference.
Yep, there's Hafford. Speaking of that man, Paul Hafford from deep gets that lead back up to 15.
6 points for Hafford. He hit two triples here in the quarter.
There's Pickett. Good look to Boogie. There's Golder. Good pump fake. Oh, caught the foul there. I believe that's on Tyreek Price. Good look at the Capitals bench there and the referees.
I mean, so far, Marcus Golder held scoreless by the Salem Capitals after having 28 points on Friday.
Yeah,
something that could really make a difference here.
Good adjustment so far by Coach Kevin Johnson right there, you know. Substitution here, Domo Lawrence back in the game for Tolbert. Tolbert put in some good minutes on the defensive side on Pickett there. Good take by Chuck. Good board by Pickett. Keeps it alive. Goes up strong again. Pickett! That's what I love to see. Feed me more. Tyshawn Pickett.
9 points for the Volcanoes for Pickett.
That's why he's my player to watch this evening. Yep. There's Matacor. You got to stay on your feet, Marcus. There's Price. Another wide open look. Luckily it didn't fall. Boogie with another board. Another boogie board. Kicks it over to Golder. Golder from deep. Got to knock it down. Yes. Marcus Golder for three.
No, he had a number of good options. He had Pickett there as well. Goes for the triple and it converts for the Volcanoes.
Cuts the lead to 10, 30 to 40. Price slows it down. Screen by Lawrence. Chuck Jones is ready to take that steal. Oh, Hafford. Oh, be careful there when the guys get tangled. Coleman. He's trying to swing everybody around there. Golder, is he going to take it again? Heat check. Oh, rebound for Hafford. Moved his feet there. You got to pick up Whitfield there. He'll make you pay. Was that the charge? Woo, beautiful play by Coleman to create the charge there. Turnover.
Coleman doing a real good, much better job here in the second quarter of leading the offense and then taking it back there for the defense to get another possession for the Volcanoes.
Here's substitution here. X coming back in. Dupree coming in for Chuck Jones. Chuck put in some good minutes there off the bench.
Yeah, very active on that offensive side.
Yep. Dupree holds his stance. Back over to Coleman. Boogie with the post on Billinger. I like that matchup. Feed it to him again. Coleman with the miss. Gentry back in the game as well. He's always tough. Good rebound there by Isaiah. There's a screen by Domo. Billinger keeps it alive. Whitfield to Gentry. Watch that post. He misses. There's Marcus with the board. There it is. Gentry tips it to Dupree. Excuse me. Dupree brings it up. Going to work on Domo. Good pass. Oh, I like the idea. Boogie from the corner. Boogie for three. Oh, Curtis loves it. Coach West also as well. Cuts the lead down to 7, 40 to 33. here with 4 minutes, 40 seconds left to go in the second quarter.
Yeah, Volcanoes can make a good push here with a good defensive stop.
Billinger with a step back. Good board there for Boogie. Here we go. Here's our chance to make a run. Marcus from deep. Ooh, follow your shot. That would have brought the house down if you would have hit that one.
Yeah, it'd be great. Get the crowd into this game.
We need an eruption, right? There it is. Turnover. We're picking up the pace a little bit here in the second quarter. A lot of it with Boogie.
And that's a really good timeout for the Capitals to kind of limit that as the Volcanoes were stretching as they cut the lead in half.
Absolutely, yeah. They're going to regroup here. 4 minutes, 12 seconds left to go. A couple more of our sponsorships. The Nike Hoop Summit. Fans, make sure you check out the Nike Hoop Summit happening April 13th. Circle your calendars and watch both male and female top prospects as they clash it out at the Moda Center. Top high school talent from the United States will go head-to-head with the top international talent. Nike Hoop Summit, today's top prospects, tomorrow's NBA and WNBA stars.
The Volcanoes thank C-Tran for providing the citizens of Clark County with safe, reliable, and convenient public transportation throughout Clark County. As Clark County grows, C-Tran will be there to provide transportation options that continue to make this a great place to work and live for everyone. Thank you, C-Tran. I'm going to thank IQ Credit Union for providing the Vancouver community with a friendly, personalized service for all of your banking needs. Whether you are planning for your first car or your first home, getting ready for college or retirement, IQ is ready to help you at every step of life's journey. See why a local approach gives you a more rewarding path to personalized banking with IQ Credit Union. And we would like to also thank Chuck E. Cheese for not only their continued support of your Vancouver Volcanoes, but also supporting the youth in our community. Have your next gathering at Chuck E. Cheese in Vancouver and enjoy hours of games, pizza, and more. Thank you, Chuck E. Cheese. That Chuck E. Cheese in Vancouver where we had that meet and greet with the team.
And Cafe Yum. Cafe Yum serves nourishing food prepared fresh and served fast with sustainable, organic, and local ingredients. Enjoy their famous Yum Bowls, wraps, kids' meals, and more at 2 Vancouver locations and 9 throughout the Portland metro area. And we are back here. 4 minutes, 12 seconds left to go in the second quarter. The Capitals with the lead, 40-33, late here in the second quarter. Let's see what kind of adjustments both teams make here.
Yeah, really good to get Marcus Golder back into the action, getting him that first 3 point. Like I said, the Capitals did a really are holding off the Volcanoes so far in 7 point lead, and they're really holding the edge still in rebounds. Although the 28-26, all the Volcanoes have cut it down here in the second quarter.
Coleman brings it up. Over to Pickett, pump fake, good pass to Golder there, beautiful play. Coleman in on the season as well. He had his season high in the last one, 14, like he brought up there. He shoots at 72.7% from the line. Misses the second. Rebound by Domo to keep it alive. Tips it to Billinger. Golder picks him up deep. Billinger goes around him. Takes it to Coleman, coast to coast. Alan Billinger, coast to coast. Builds that lead back up to 9.
Leading scorer here in this game with 16 points.
Again, they got numerous guys that can kill you multiple ways. And Alan Billinger, again, big shout to him last season. Was an all-star. Good take. Coleman coast to coast. Misses it, though.
Just
right to Molson.
Didn't get that to fall.
Yep. Over to Whitfield. Whitfield up and caught Boogie with the foul there. Whitfield's tough. He's super quick when he has the ball, and he's really good with his spin moves there.
Yeah, and he also had 14 points for the Capitals on Friday night.
Yeah, which is well low below his season average, you know, 19.5, and he had 25 in that first one. Here comes Chuck Jones back in, checking in for Boogie Ford, who's picked up another foul there, which I believe was his third foul already. Jones matched up on Whitfield. You got to move your feet. There's Whitfield. Misses right to Coleman, though. Rashawn, that is. There it is. That's another one, too. You can't – it's hard to create a charge with players like Rashawn Coleman, Preston Whitfield, Alan Billinger. They're all super lightning quick out there.
Yeah, it's really good when you take advantage of a defensive player's aggressiveness and get him to draw that foul.
Coleman at the line. One of two here. And just barely rolls off on the first one. Substitution here. Here's a debut here on the season. We got Taylor Webster making his season debut here, coming in for Preston Whitfield. The Capitol fans are excited to see him out there.
Yeah, Whitfield picking up his third foul.
Yeah, that's huge. Whitfield is a huge piece to their success. Rashawn knocks down the second. Billinger slowly bringing it up. Coleman right there with him. We got 37-45 right now with 2:10 left to go. Good hands by Pickett. It's staying here, but that was really smart play there. And luckily, they didn't draw a foul there.
And we're still 9 seconds on the shot clock. See if the Volcanoes can shut down this possession.
There's Gentry. Good tip there by Caleb to create the turnover. Picks it up to Chuck Jones. Chuck, crossover, misses. Gets his own board. Goes up strong. Good aggressiveness, Chuck Jones there. That's what I like to see out of Chuck.
Yeah, staying aggressive on that. I'm sorry, when you get a possession there like Coleman got for you, you know, get involved in there and get to the line.
Absolutely. Let's see if we can knock down a pair here. Chuck Jones on the season, averaging 8.7 points per game, 2 rebounds, and his high on the season is 12. Played at David Douglas High School in Portland, Oregon. Misses the first, where he was a 2-time high school All-State.
8 for 12 tonight from the free throw line are the Vancouver Volcanoes so far.
Shot number two here. Oh, in and out.
Missed the pair.
Webster bringing it up. Jones matched up on him. Good defense by Chuck. What happened? Chuck forced a turnover? Yes, he did. Good defense, Chuck, there. Chuck Jones.
Yeah, that's a great way to get a contribution off the bench. Not only being aggressive on the offensive end, but forcing turnovers on the defensive side.
Yeah, maybe a little bit of debut jitters a little bit for Taylor Webster as well. You know, it's his first opportunity putting on that Capitals jersey. Jones from deep. Misses. Rebounded by Smith. Over to Billinger. Billinger pushes. Billinger, the crossover. Misses. Coleman can't keep a hold of it there. Looks like we're staying here with the Capitals. Looks like we're staying here. Salem ball. 1:23 left to go. And over to Moe. Over to Webster. Kicks it back over to Gentry. Gentry matched up with Caleb Coleman. He takes it. Good take. Good defense. Marcus Golder. Rebound by Pickett. Caleb Coleman pushes. Knocked out by Webster. We're staying right here. One minute, 8 seconds left to go in the second quarter. Timeout, Vancouver. 1:08 left to go in the second quarter. Salem Capitals lead 45-37. Tonight's game is dedicated to Chelsea's Closet as well. They're here with some raffles and some great gifts up here. Great sponsorship for tonight. So interesting to see what both these huddles will be talking about here, how to close out the quarter here. They both want to finish strong because they want to make great adjustments going into the second half here. Another thing, too, we want to shout out to the youth clinics as well. They're a major focus of the Volcanoes, and the best way to learn your fundamentals and work on skills is alongside your Volcanoes players and coaches. Sign up for one of our weekly youth clinics at the Marshall Center in Vancouver or a multi-day spring break camp and enjoy hours of skill building alongside your Volcanoes. Registration is available at VancouverVolcanoes.com. We will see you there. And we are back here for the closing. Here, Coleman inbounds to Chuck here. Chuck Jones going to work. Tipped there by Domo. Keeps it alive. He's matched up on Billinger. Post up. Good move, Chuck Jones. Lets it to fall there. Chuck Jones with his first basket of the evening. 39-45. Just under 50 seconds left to go in the second quarter. Billinger slowing it down here. Golder picking him up here. See what he does here. Good crossover. That's his move. Beautiful shot there. Alan Billinger, he is tough. The All-Star. 47-39. 30 seconds left to go. Here's Pickett. Down to Caleb Coleman. Oh, what a turnover. Good help there. Gentry and Domo there. Billinger pushes it again. 17 seconds. Golder's got him. Picking him up. Over to Gentry. Good take. Rebound by Domo. Good help by Chuck. He forces the foul there. Looks like Domo's going to go to the line for a pair with 4.2 seconds left to go. 47-39. Domo's patented prayer before each free throw. That's kind of his move there. And on the season, it definitely pays dividends where he's averaged 13 points on the season, 3.5 rebounds, including that 21 performance in the opener. He knocks down the first. Here comes the second. And it rolls out in the second. Good rebound by Caleb Coleman. 2-1. Throws it from half court. Barely off there. So, ladies and gentlemen, live here from Hudson's Bay High School in Vancouver, Washington, the Salem Capitals lead 48-39. And now we're going to get ready to go to, we're going to swing it over to my partner, James, here for a halftime interview here. He's going to talk to Coach West here on the sidelines. Well, we got a little delay here. Both teams walking into the locker room here. And so far, you know, this first half, that three-point line has really made a difference for Salem here, where they have hit 36% to our 21% has made a difference. And at the free throw line, you know, actually we've outshot them tonight. It's 77% to 66%. Here's a good look at Domo there, talking with our coaching staff there. And here's our partner, James, here waiting by for an interview here. Hopefully we can get a word with him before we cut to break. And so far, you know, leading the way there is Billinger. He's been on fire so far with 19 points here in this first half. And for us leading the way, we got a couple guys here with 9 apiece. We got Miles and Pickett both with 9 to lead the way as well. Let's see what kind of adjustments we will make in this second half. So we are going to, actually the word I got, we are going to go to halftime. Hopefully we can maybe replay that interview, but we will see you soon. Oh, here he comes. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen. Little mix up here, but here's James. Good word here with Ty West. Let's see what we got.
All right, we're here with Coach West. Alan Billinger, looked like he was hot shooting as anybody has ever seen there in the first half. How can you help limit his opportunities in the second half?
Well, we got to okay. Getting the screen set too low and it's in his comfort range. Allen in every shot and making it.
All right. That said, there in the second quarter, you cut that lead back down to 9 points under double digits. Really good minutes there from Chuck Jones. What kind of spark did you see him giving you when he came into the game?
He's one of our best defenders, and he can also score the ball well, so he's a big piece for us. Right now, and this is our third game in 4 days, so I'm happy with the position we're in because it could be worse, you know. So I'm hopefully these guys pick it up the second half and have better energy.
Yeah, we'll see if we can flip the script as we've had the last two games and come back strong here in the third quarter. Thank you so much, Coach West. Right back up to you, David.
Volcanoes, get ready for that home opener this Friday night against the Salem Capitals. The I-5 rivalry is live and it's kicking. It should be a good one. They've met 21 times. Unfortunately, Salem has got the best of us, but I think this year things are going to be changing. There's a lot of new faces here, new coaching staff helping out, lots of new bodies. Let's look at some of the highlights from last night.
Ain't no way they can stop me now, daddy, cause I'm on my way, I can feel my ring coming.
Fun. This could be fun today. This could be fun today. My legs must try to
be running. I'ma get what I can and more, even if my blood, my sweat, and my tears don't mean nothing. It's the heart of a champion. It's the heart of a
right, David Mace here, one of your spokespersons for the Vancouver Volcanoes. I'm sitting here with Tyshawn Pickett. Tyshawn, it's a pleasure to meet you finally.
Thank you. It's a pleasure.
So you're from Passaic, New Jersey, and you played community college at Dodge City for a couple seasons and University of Bradley, so you played with the Braves. Talk about some of your experiences there at the collegiate level.
Coming from Passaic, coming from high school, I wasn't expected to go to college, actually. But it turned out that I was pretty good at basketball, so I started from a young age, and I just grew up. And then I wanted to go away for school. I didn't want to stay in New Jersey, so Dodge City was a great place in the Jayhawk Conference. Mm-hmm. It was one of the conferences out there in Kansas, so I wanted to take my talents, you know, showcase myself. And it paid off well. I spent 2 years there, graduated, then I went on to playing in Bradley University for the rest of my day, 2 years. And that right there was an amazing conference, Missouri Valley Conference. There was a lot of competition, and it taught me a lot about being a pro basketball player. Mm-hmm. I'm in college, you know, so it was awesome, man. It was really awesome.
That's awesome. Yeah, I'm excited. I hear you're just a dog down low, just a beast. And, you know, you start off 18 points, 12 boards in that first game. Congratulations on that first victory. How would you compare, like, the camaraderie with this new team? There's a lot of new faces. I know Curtis has been raving about you for a long time.
Talk about the team a little bit.
The team is great, actually. We have a great, great chemistry together. You know, we just met, most of us, you know, we just got out here, but the chemistry is like we've been together for a couple years. It's great players. We have, you know, one player that won a championship with another team that knows the league. So, you know, he's our point guard. So it's just awesome having him, you know, and me just to be down low in the paint, to have a presence and just to be that big for him.
Absolutely. Well, Tyshawn, it was a pleasure. Looking forward to calling your games throughout the season.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Stay healthy, my friend.
Yes, sir. Nice to meet you.
We are live here at Evergreen High School here, practice for your Vancouver Volcanoes. We want to do a big shout out to Coach C at Evergreen for being gracious and letting us use their practice gym. As you can see in the back, they're all ready for this week. We have some interviews coming up. We interviewed some staff, a few players, and also some of our sponsorship as well. The guys are ready for a big weekend. Hi, my name is David Mace, one of the voices of your Vancouver Volcanoes. I have the pleasure here with our marketing director, Brad Lechtenberg, and hoop legend for the Volcanoes. Brad, always great to see you, my friend.
Thank you, David. It's great to be here. Appreciate it.
And so my first question is, so let's talk about some of the sponsorships, like the process that you go through on trying to recruit potential sponsors for the Vancouver Volcanoes.
Well, everything that we're trying to do is really, it starts with the community. It starts with getting the work done and building relationships. When we, you know, we have an opportunity with our sponsorships where we have media, we have the live broadcasts, we have banners and different things like that. But what we really try to do is find ways to connect with the community and find support for those programs. Our youth clinics are a big deal. Every time that we're talking to sponsors, I'm usually talking about our youth clinics. We're talking about supporting them, whether it's with gear or t-shirts or jerseys or scholarships, providing new opportunities for kids to participate. I think that our strongest piece in the community is the service that we're able to provide, getting these guys in there, working with kids, giving kids great opportunity with some good role models and things like that. A lot of companies and a lot of organizations want to partner with people who are making that real difference, not just throwing up a banner or not just running a commercial. We do those things, but usually it's in partnership with one of our programs, and that's kind of where we really do a good job.
Yeah, I love that idea, you know, building the futures with the kids in the community and sharpening up their basketball skills and building those relationships are really important. And talk about some of the sponsors we have sponsoring us this season.
Well, some of our sponsors have really been great for a long time. We'll start with Yoder Chiropractic. He's our official team chiropractor. He came on with the Volcanoes in 2010. I personally have been treated on a number of injuries with him, and also just maintenance and general health and wellness. We also have Waste Connections, who's back for another year. They're our official community partner. Everybody in Vancouver knows what a great job they do of supporting all the different things that we have going on as a community and a lot of those initiatives. RV and Style is a great partner for us. We've done our media day with them 2 years in a row now. We're really enjoying working with them and building out that relationship and seeing it grow. Cafe Yum is back. Cafe Yum does a great job supporting our nonprofits in our fundraising games. They support with Yum Bowls and some product and things, and we just really appreciate them coming back and joining us again as well. This year we have Chris Green with State Farm. He's a local real estate agent, does a lot with East Vancouver Business Association and Kim Blonick. So we're really excited to have his support in partnership this year as well. We also have Chuck E. Cheese. We did a great fundraiser and a Meet the Team event at Chuck E. Cheese. They also support us with some different prizes and some different fun cards that the kids can win and different in-game promotions and things like that. We also have C-Tran with us this year. C-Tran is partnering and using their marketing muscle. You'll see our different ticket information and things on their channel cards on the Vine, which is going to be awesome this year. We have a 25% discount for all bus riders to come to Volcano Games this year. You can show your hot pass at the door, or you can also scan the QR code on the bus and catch a Volcano game. We also have Pop Local. Check out Pop Local. You're going to see some custom Vancouver Volcano merch this year in Pop Local. We're working on some really cool lifestyle merchandise and options that you can only find exclusively in Pop Local. They've been great with us for a couple years now. We're excited to have them back. We're really excited to work with IQ Credit Union this year. We're putting some different programs together with them as our financial literacy sponsor. IQ does a lot of great things for this community, and we're really fortunate to have them come on board and be a part of our team as well.
And lastly, so let's have a little fun. Looks like you were a celebrity, you and X-Man and Rashawn Coleman were on TV, got interviewed. Talk a little bit about that.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. We went down to COIN and we shot a segment, which was great. And X did awesome. Rashawn did awesome. It was good to spread the good news about the volcanoes and the different things we're doing in our community. But also a shout out to COIN and kind of how that came through. Started with Jamie Hudson, who used to be a sideline reporter for the Volcanoes and got her start here working under Bobby P. We also had Nicole DaCosta over there. And everything about the Volcanoes platform is all about opportunity. It's about stepping stone. It's about giving people in this community an opportunity to kind of polish their skills and level up to get into those next opportunities. And this is just another example of that happening with the Volcanoes organization.
Absolutely. Well, Brad, I really enjoyed this time. I can talk to you all day. It's always great to see you.
Thanks,
good luck,
David.
On the season. Thank you.
Appreciate it.
I'm here with another nice guest who's very valuable to the organization, Assistant Manager Josh Newton. Josh, it's always a pleasure to see you.
It's a pleasure, David.
How are you doing this evening?
Oh, I'm doing great. Super excited for this season.
Absolutely. So my first question is, let's talk a little bit about our internship here in the organization.
Yeah, so big focus of the organization, especially this year, is internships. We have four interns this year. One's working with media, one with sales and partnerships, another with media relations, and then the last one helping with productions and operations. So we're really trying to focus on helping them grow in their careers, kind of helping them find that avenue that they whatever they want to do in the sports industry, and giving them the tools for their success, and really just trying to give them the platform to do whatever they want with their career.
Absolutely. Great stuff. I've had a pleasure watching you grow in your role in the organization from last year. You just do a little bit of everything, and you're uploading a lot of the pictures and everything on our website, and it's always such a pleasure. Let's talk about the team a little bit this year. What have you seen in game one and looking forward to this three-game stretch coming into this weekend?
Yeah, so I had the ability to go down to Eugene during our first game, see the guys play live. By the way, I hats off to the Jaguars. They do a phenomenal job down there. The team's exciting this year. Now I had the ability to do stats last year for us, and it's a different vibe this year. We got a lot of younger guys, but a lot of guys that have played on TBL teams before and have professional experience. Great personalities this year. Love all the guys. I'm super excited to see what they're able to do.
Absolutely. Well, Josh, thank you for your time. It's always a pleasure and can't wait to work with you this season.
Of course. Same.
Thank you.
We are live back here at Hudson's Bay High School for the second half of the TBL matchup between the Vancouver Volcanoes and the Salem Capitals. Our leaders so far in the first half here on the Salem Capitals side is Alan Billinger leads the way with 18 points here for them. And then they've had it kind of spread out throughout. With us, same thing, but it's been Miles and Pickett both with 9 apiece. And
yeah, Miles came off the bench, giving them some offense tonight, and also some real good effort from Chuck Jones there in the second quarter, as we heard Coach West say in the halftime interview.
Absolutely, yeah. Chuck Jones brought on some great energy, great minutes, great defense, and a couple nice shots there as well.
Yeah, but 9 points apiece for Miles and Pickett to lead the way. They want to get Marcus Golder back in the action. He only had 5 points in the first half. That could be a big boost to the Volcanoes to take back this lead from the Capitals.
And looks like our starting fives for the second half, it looks like we got our same units as the first half. So number 2 at point guard, we have Rashawn Coleman, with number 11, Marcus Golder. Boogie Ford, number 4. Number 1, Xavier Nupri. And the man in the middle, Tyshawn Pickett, number 21. for the Capitals. We got number 11, Preston Whitfield with the steal right there. We got Domo Lawrence 2, number 0, Zaya Gentry. And we got also Alan Billinger, number 3, and then number 10, Mo Smith. Looks like they called Golder on a foul there.
Golder met him at the rim as he was going for that dunk. He definitely thought that was a clean block.
Yeah, it was close.
I think it's going to be key. We're looking at a 9-point deficit. It's going to be key for the Volcanoes to limit the amount of to up their discipline, to limit the amount of frustration they're feeling on the court. It'll really help them as they try to come back, because it's 9 points is not insurmountable at all.
And Preston Whitfield, last season I gave him the nickname Mr. Fourth Quarter because he was always so big for them. Last year in the fourth quarter, he's worked his way up to the starting lineup this season. He played with us for the Volcanoes in the Tijuana Classic in the tournament, helped lead us to a second place in that tournament, and then he hits both here, 91% on the season, averaging 19.5, and they just forced another turnover on us.
And you can feel the excitement on the Capitals bench. Not only did they get that lead back up to 11, but they get the possession right back.
And what was one of my keys to the game? That third quarter. We have to take care of this third quarter, getting off to a fast start, because that's where we've really struggled so far in these last two matchups. The adjustments. We got to make them better here. And here comes Golder with the board, brings it up, takes it all the way. Ooh, we're not getting that roll, but there's Pickett.
Yeah, the rims have not been Pickett friendly, again. But that one goes down for Pickett to get him to 11 points.
Tyshawn Pickett with the bucket there.
And I can tell you, it was a big amount of frustration on for Domo there coming out of the first half. He was not happy with the way that he was getting defended and getting some physicality from the Volcanoes.
Absolutely. It seems like, too, Salem does a really good job, like, after we score a bucket. They did it the other night, too. Good spin by Boogie Ford. Good strip by Billinger. But it seems like once we score a basket, they're pushing it quick to try to catch us with numbers. And we need to adjust getting back on defense.
I mean, and you can definitely tell that was the way that the Volcanoes wanted to play coming into this game. They wanted to play a half-court style, and they might have to do an adjustment there to go towards what the Capitals have been, how the Capitals have been playing them, both offensively and defensively.
Absolutely. This is a really important game in our division, too. Good rebound there. Golder. 41-52. Marcus pushing again, going to toast to coast. Marcus Golder, ladies and gentlemen. 43-52, 9-point game with 10.5 left to go early here in the third quarter. Gentry with the ball here, gets the screen by Mo Smith. Over to Domo. Preston with the step back. Gentry deep, misses. There's X. He was brilliant the other night with his rebounds last game. Let's see if he continues it this game. And no, did they just call Pickett offense again? I believe so. That's that fourth foul there, and he's going to have to come out. Marky Adams getting ready to check in, but.
And Pickett does not want to leave this game. He was just getting into the flow of things offensively and defensively, and we'll see what kind of minutes that Marky Adams can give to make up for that.
Yeah, and then for me, the game plan still doesn't change on offense. You know, when Pickett comes out and Marky comes in, we should continue to try to feed Marky the ball as well in the post and get him going, because Marky can light it up. Like I said, last game, he put up 42 against Wenatchee in that one, and he has the capabilities to put up those numbers. Golder taking over. It's like he caught a hard foul there, I believe, on Whitfield there.
You know, Golder's really one of those lanky players. That's really an interesting choice on his part, to give up that three-point shot and get in the middle, force the action, force them to foul him so he can get those points. It can really have a good effect for the Volcanoes if he's being aggressive, getting towards the rim and causing those fouls on a guy like Billinger.
Yeah, good point there. This is the first trip for Marcus at the free throw line this evening, where on the season he's been shooting it really well. You know, he's 89.5% from the foul line. And he's had a really great start to this season so far. You know, him and Marky, the two veterans on this roster, trying to engrave their names, stepping up, you know, with all the new faces here.
Yeah, first half, Volcanoes were 9 of 15 from the line. That is something Coach West said he'd like to see them improve on, get those free points when they got the chance to do it.
Looks like another substitution as well. Oh. Had Devontae Cleveland checking in for Preston Whitfield. Marcus knocks down the first. And buries the second. 45-52 cuts that lead down to 7. I'm looking for a run here. Who's the player? I'm going to have you pick out a player. Who's our guy here who's going to lead this charge for a run here in this third quarter?
Well, Marcus Goller has already cemented himself on that. But it would be great to see also Rashawn Coleman, our player of the game in the last game, do that as well.
Yeah, no, great point there. And after that, Mo Smith just buries another 3 for the Capitals. Here comes Coleman. Coleman matched up with Cleveland. Good spin by Coleman. Misses. Markey, go up strong. Markey, great job drawing the foul there. Markey's going to go to the line here.
I mean, that's a great effort by Markey Adams. Definitely a way that he can affect this game if he can come in and replace those minutes by Tyshawn Pickett.
Also want to do a quick shout-out to Brian down there as our announcer down there, our head announcer down there, filling in for the great Robert Jones. Brian does a great job down there. Markey knocks down the first free throw. There's a great look at Brian right there and our great statistician team and Josh Newton as well.
And then also, let's remember, Mike Koreski watching us at home already. We know he is. And he, as he's convalescing to get back here broadcast side, we're going to look forward to getting the wireless mic back in here in the action.
Yes, Mike is always missed here. He is the voice of the Volcanoes. Mike, I know you're at home recuperating. We love you. Can't wait to have you back out here. Coleman misses. Good finish by Boogie Ford and 1.
It's a really good defense down there for the Volcanoes.
And there it is. There it is. Timeout here. Early in the third quarter, the Capitals with the lead 55-49, 8 minutes, 47 seconds left to go.
They've already cut the lead down to 6 with a chance to make it 5 if we can complete this 3-point play.
We'll be right back here, ladies and gentlemen.
Hi, my name is Jessica Chan, founder of Pop Local. And Pop Local was a concept that came out of the pandemic when events were shut down. Like, we were looking for a way to pivot and continue to support a lot of the small businesses that we did in the event space that we were no longer able to do through a large public gathering in the form of events. For Pop Local, our new storefront here, we currently have just over 80 brands that are represented. We have a lot of products in the pipeline that we're excited to get in. I feel like we are easily will be home to 100 plus in the next couple weeks here. I started on the maker side of things myself. I studied industrial design and used to be at markets myself promoting my own products, and that really grew a love for me connecting with other entrepreneurs and people that are trying to get started in the business world. And I saw how important it was to have your products in front of people and that interaction, and just to grow your brand and your story that way and being able to get that exposure. I mean, I couldn't be more grateful for the community's response on both the small business on the vendor side. I think especially through the pandemic, people are very intentional about shopping local now more than ever to support one another, and to something that we really are mindful about is keeping it hyper local. And I guess what I mean by that is all our brands are pretty much within a half an hour radius of us. There's so much creative talent that's right within our neighborhood that we really want to shine light on and support here, and to really fuel that local economy.
All right, we are back here live from Hudson's Bay High School, and I want to do a quick shout out. I mentioned them a little bit. Our fundraiser game partner tonight is the Chelsea Hicks Foundation, Chelsea's Closet. It's a rolling dress-up closet that provides monthly dress-up parties for seriously ill children in children's hospitals. Their goal is to bring a smile to children's faces and joy to their hearts. The children have an opportunity to select a complete new costume of their choice with accessories. The Chelsea Hicks Foundation hosts a party and a parade around the ward to show off the costumes. For many of the kids, this will be their one time out of their rooms for the day. Children unable to leave their rooms have an opportunity to select a new costume, a craft project, and a goodie bag. Chelsea's Closet provides hope and healing for seriously ill children from all 36 Oregon counties, reaching more than 2,300 children and their families each year. Let's thank Chelsea's Closet for the incredible work they do for the community and partnering to bring you tonight's game. And there's Salem.
Mauricio Smith again, getting a bucket down there on the block. He's got 8 points.
Builds the lead back up to 7, 50-57. Boogie going to work. Post up, misses. Dupree gets a hand in it, and it looks like it's off him with Gentry.
And Boogie Ford did cut it down to 5 with that free throw before we got the Capitol scoring on their end. And we got 7 points for Boogie Ford on the game.
And Billinger brings it up with the screen by Mo Smith. Goes to Markey, pump fake. It's the easy bucket there. Alan Billinger's had a night tonight.
Breaking into 20 points on the game for Alan Billinger, who they have not had much of an answer for so far in this game.
Yep, the all-star. I call him the all-star. Beautiful finish there by Boogie Ford. 52-59. There's Zay going to work on X. Buries it. Zay Gentry.
Yeah, beautiful touch on that by Isaiah Gentry.
Yeah, it's tough to defend that shot. Coleman brings it up. The lead's back up to 9. 7.5 left to go in the third quarter. Boogie has a mismatch here on Billinger. Let's see if they go with that matchup, but Domo read that right away and just took it away. Billinger to Cleveland. Cleveland going at Markey. Good D, Markey, to stand your ground. Tips it to Coleman. Coleman all the way, coast to coast. There's Sean Coleman, ladies and gentlemen. Cuts it down to 7. 54-61. He talked about Coleman earlier.
Yep, 4 rebounds now, 5 points for Rashawn Coleman.
It's time to go to work. Good crossover by Billinger. Billinger for deep. That's one of those Capital Five I always mention. Lead back up to 10.
And you can see he's working out. He's down here on the near side of the court, and he is feeling it.
Yeah. Allen was a little frustrated from, you know, last game, so he's trying to make it count tonight. He knows how important this game is for the Capitals and the standings. You don't want to fall to an 0-3 deficit and get that far behind. Good foul there. Good take by Dupree there. Good way to pass the ball around.
Yeah, they were giving good motion on there on that offense. Really good shot, but also really good effort to get that ball back and get it to end. Golder with a great pass down there to Dupree.
Good minutes there for Markey. The coaches were letting him know there. Good moment as well. Up, good block. Billinger up to Cleveland. Cleveland to Mo Smith again. Mo Smith is having a night, ladies and gentlemen. Another 3 for Mo.
11 points for Smith.
Mo wants Mo.
Yeah, that transition jump shooting is really doing well for the Capitals tonight.
Build that lead up to 67-54, Salem. Good take with Coleman to Golder. Beautiful take by Golder across. Way to take the foul there. Draw the foul. Golder going back to the free throw line.
Yeah, just the rim's not kind tonight to the Vancouver Volcanoes. They've had a number of opportunities like they're just come off the rim. Golder, though, has worked his point total up to 9 points here with some good scoring here in the third quarter, so it'll look to add to it from the line.
Yeah, he's came alive a little bit. A nice little spark. And buries the first, cuts the lead to 12, 55-67. Marcus again on the season, averaging 25 points a game, 4.7 rebounds.
When you see a slightly a smaller lineup out there for the Volcanoes as they brought in Coleman to replace Markey Adams.
Yeah, because, you know, the foul trouble also with Pickett there. They're going a little bit more of a small ball here. And Gentry again responds. 69-56. Ford brings it up. Looks like Miles about to check in. Coleman. Rashawn Coleman. Beautiful shot there.
I mean, they are going back and forth. It's a prize fight out there tonight here in the third quarter.
Yeah, we're not going to win this game if we keep going back and forth. We need to make a little bit of a run here. Get it closer. Couple stops. And here's a good look here at Rashawn Coleman's last basket. Swish.
Yeah, that pop jumper to give him the 7 points.
One of the best sounds in the world. Thomas Miles getting ready to check back in as well. Who's he checking in for?
Miles giving him 9 points in the first half off the bench. See if he can give him that another spark here.
Yeah, I think there was a little bit of an injury timeout there. I think somebody there. Not sure what happened there. Devon Bolton also getting ready to check in. So it looks like we're trying to get some three-point shooters in here. When you bring Miles and Bolton in there.
Maybe. Also just trying to find a mix that'll work on our end and see if we can limit their opportunities on the defensive end as well.
Yeah. Mo Smith back to Billinger. Billinger with the crossover. Oh, good help by Caleb Coleman, but leaves Cleveland open. Cleveland misses. Billinger with the offensive board. Another second chance opportunity for the Capitals. Beautiful take by Cleveland. We have to stay on our feet. And now they get the opportunity for the and one. Looked like the foul was on an X, Xavier Dupree. And here comes Bolton and Miles checking in for Coleman and Boogie Ford. So we're definitely going smaller here as well.
Yeah, and then to see maybe some more perimeter shooting as well.
Yeah, that's exactly what they're looking to do here.
Because we saw Dupree made a number of good shots for them there in the fourth quarter and last game on Friday.
Yeah, we're looking to run. And he completes the three-point play. 72-58. Those Miles. Yep, there it is. One pass. There's X, though, with the board. Good help with the block. X marks the spot. Beautiful shot there. Cuts the lead to 12. Now we need to stop. 72-60.
4 points, five rebounds for Xavier Dupree.
Gentry with the post up. Gentry deep on Golder. There's not much more Marcus could have done on that shot. It was just better offense. Beautiful stroke for Zay Gentry there. There's the lob to Golder. Gentry read it. Billinger pushes up to Cleveland. Cleveland takes it on Coleman. Draws the foul for two. The momentum just seems to clearly be on that Capitals side most of the afternoon.
Yeah, they push the lead now to 15 points and we get two free throws here.
Cleveland, he was on this roster last year as well. Really good defender there for the Capitals. And an underrated offensive game as well. He averages 10 points on the season. You know, one rebound, two assists, and a block. So he does a little bit of everything. Even from the three-point line, he's averaged 66% as well. And he knocks down the first.
Yeah, but you can see over on the Volcanoes bench, Coach Hampton and Hill and West, they're really trying to find the mix that will get them back into this game as the lead's now grown to 17 points.
Yep, not reach there for Billinger there. 77-60, 4 minutes, 20 seconds left to go. There's a great look at Kim Blonick. Josh Newton, our stat buddy there in the middle. And Brian there waiting for a big play to call, waiting for an eruption.
And then maybe here from the line, we can get some points to get back and to get this lead down.
Here's Coleman, misses the first. Saul Matacor coming in too, first time in the second half. Number 14 for the Salem Capitals. Good angle here, good view of that free throw, and Coleman knocks down the second. 61-77, 4 minutes, 14 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Good crossover by Billinger. Good help by Golder. Billinger's left, though. Rare miss for Billinger tonight. Bolton with the board. Bolton pushes. Takes it to Zay. Draws the foul. Great play there by Devon Bolton. Zay Gentry does not agree with it. Bolton to shoot one of two here. We're on the season. Bolton averages 10.3 on the season, including 38.5% from the three-point line. He had his high score of 16 in Seattle. Actually in Emerald City.
And a chance for Bolton to cut this lead back down to 15 if he can hit this one, which he
knocks
does.
Knocks it down. Gentry posting Miles. Thomas Miles up. There's his step back. Good rebound by Dupree. Dupree's basically playing center right now out there. Good move. Oh, a little sloppy there. It went to Goller. Bounced off the foot of Billinger. It's staying right here.
I always like the effort when the big men can push the ball up the court like that. But in this case, where we have four ball handlers on the court there capable of doing that, we need Dupree to get back in that low block and give it a chance to set up an offense to try and get this perimeter. That's the one thing we haven't seen is them really try to set up a perimeter game.
Yeah. Rebound by Billinger. Billinger pushes to Cleveland. Jump stop. Draws the foul on Coleman. Coleman was looking for the block there, and Cleveland, very heads-up move. That's a veteran move to stop there and draw the foul. Cleveland was looking for the three-point play, but we'll see if Cleveland knocked down this pair. ...77-62 right now with 3:20 left to go. I'm interested to see if this run's going to happen. Cleveland knocks down the first.
Looks like we'll have Anderson coming into the game to replace Coleman, leaving with four fouls.
Yeah, we've really gotten foul trouble again tonight. It's next man up mentality. Cleveland knocks them both down. Bolton bringing it up. Bolton taking it again. Devon Bolton, beautiful.
6 points for Devon Bolton.
Let's see what we got. Cleveland getting ready to inbound. Looks like we're going to start putting a little more pressure on here, see if we can create a turnover. The guy we don't want the hands on the ball here is Billinger. It's tough to take it away from him. Good contested shot there. Rebounded by Dupree. Here we go. Let's push it with this lineup. Bolton for three. Devon Bolton for three. Cuts the lead down to 12. Devon Bolton's been that spark these last few possessions.
That's his second three-pointer in the game. Gets his point total up to 9.
Just under his season average. Good help by Bolton. Let's see, he might have got Bolton on the foul here. Yeah, Bolton with the foul here. Looks like we got a timeout here for Salem. They see that Vancouver's going on a little run here. So your score with 2 minutes, 33 seconds left to go in the third quarter, the Salem Capitals lead the Vancouver Volcanoes 79-67.
Yeah, we're coming under here under the three-minute mark.
All right, we're going to talk about Yoder Chiropractic. Here is our commercial. We'll be right back.
We provide care for anybody and everybody, especially children and the elderly. In addition to chiropractic care, we also offer nutritional consulting, exercise consulting, massage therapy.
I had neck pain, I had back pain, I was low on energy. I came in and Dr. Yoder totally took a full body approach. He was able to give me healing in my neck, my back, I have more energy. They just educated me and I love this place, they're wonderful.
My philosophy is to get to the root of the problem and not just the overlying pain. So we want to really figure out what the one thing that you need to correct to get back to the best health you can possibly be in. But if you're watching this video on Facebook, go ahead, if you haven't already, click the like button towards the top of the page. While you're on our page, go ahead and submit the most important question you have regarding wellness. Through the diagnostic process that you'll have when you come to this office, very thorough exam, possibly x-rays, and the other computerized tests that we do, we'll be able to pinpoint and find exactly what it is that you're gonna need for you. What I love about my job is meeting people on a daily basis that have lost hope, but now can ride a bike, can play with their grandkids, can walk their dog, the simple things in life. If you're somebody that's been wondering if chiropractic or a wellness doctor could be right for you, I am confident that we can help you. Please give us a call.
Hi, my name is Jessica Chan, founder of Pop Local, and Pop Local was a concept that came out of the pandemic. When events were shut down, like, we were looking for a way to pivot and continue to support a lot of.
All right, we are back here late in the third quarter here. 67-79. James, what jumps out on the stat sheet for you, my man?
Oh, just, you know, not really being able to go on a big run for Vancouver to kind of press the Capitals into making the kind of mistakes that you can get when you get pressure on them.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. Cleveland knocks down that free throw there. Build the lead back up to 13.
I think you said they're just giving up too many perimeter opportunities to the Capitals there. 13 from 30 from 3 points. They're going to 43%. It's going to be hard when you're facing a team that's shooting that good and you're not taking advantage of it on your side to kind of generate the offense you're looking for.
Yep. And he knocks down both free throws there. There's Courtney Anderson bringing it up. Billinger meeting him there. Good screen by Dupree. Back to Dupree. Oh, got to handle that. Matacor back in the game here as well for Salem. Bolton. Bolton for three. Ooh, that would have went down. That would have been huge. Good rebound by X, though. X marks the spot, baby. 69-81. Xavier Dupree with a big bucket.
6 points, 9 boards for Xavier Dupree, showing that overall game that's really been an impact for the Volcanoes so far this season.
Yeah, he's an under-the-radar guy. I'm waiting for that big explosive game. I feel like it's going to happen at some point. Looks like we got a foul here.
And that'll send the Capitals back to the line. At Cleveland, who already has 12 points here in this game, doing really good scoring for the Capitals here in the third quarter.
Yeah, it looks like they got a couple substitutions getting ready to check in as well for the Capitals here. Like Paul Hafford coming in for Isaiah Gentry. Gentry's had another solid night tonight so far with 5 rebounds, 10 points, 2 steals as well, 4 assists. Here's Cleveland. Cleveland seems to be living at the free throw line this third quarter. And he buries them both.
Yeah, exactly.
He's doing a good job drawing the fouls.
8 for 8 from the free throw line, up to 14 points, which gives him 9 for the quarter.
Oh, Anderson loses the handle. There's Bolton wide open. That's your shot, Devon. Devon Bolton, baby. There we go. 72-83. Devon Bolton from downtown. He is definitely been our third quarter spark. Matched up with Hafford there. Billinger goes right around, wide open. Matacor, he stops, goes to work, finds a wide open Domo Lawrence. Thomas Miles got a little bit lost. He wasn't sure who was matched up with who. Courtney Anderson bringing it up. Crossover over to Boogie Ford. Oh, Bolton's block. Cleveland was ready. He was baiting him for that one. Cleveland pushing again. Jump ball. Beautiful block on Boogie Ford to cause the jump ball to.
Yeah, I've seen some of the coaches mention how Boogie Ford likes to get that two-handed block.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a jump ball. And looks like Tyreek Price getting ready to check back in. And also Jameel Tolbert.
He has a third block shot for Elijah Ford in this game.
And Curtis and Calvin definitely little optimistic of what they're seeing out there. Here's Miles. Miles for three. Here we go. Here's a short little run here to cut it to 10. We got to get it to single digits before the end of the quarter.
Yeah, first points in the third quarter for Miles. It gets down 12 points for the game.
We need a stop and at least another bucket before the end of this quarter. That'll put us in good shape going into the fourth to get that momentum. Kind of like the Seattle game. We had that big three right at the end of the quarter. And there goes Miles again. Miles is pushing on Hafford. Miles, oh, he misses, but he crossed the foul on Hafford. That would have brought down the house if that would have went down.
Yeah, that would have blown the roof off the mountain. That's what I'd call it here.
The lava would be flowing. Thomas Miles here to shoot one.
You can tell the crowd is just waiting. Yes. They're waiting for those that moment to really to jump up and give the Volcanoes that extra.
I'm waiting for that big yell myself.
That great breakaway there and almost got that down. Yep. Just right off the back rim. But drawing that foul, that's going to be good if you can nail it.
Miles knocks down the first. Miles on this evening is
13 points, 4 rebounds. He's 5 for 5 from the free throw line.
That's what I like to see. 6 for 6 now. There we go. Single digits, what I asked for. 85-77. We got to get a stop. No basket here. Don't bail him out the free throw line either. Smart play. Price with the crossover. Beautiful pass over to Tolbert. Kicks it back to Hafford. You know he's taking... No. That is the last thing we needed there. Devon Bolton with the... You never want to foul a three-point shooter, especially somebody like Paul Hafford who shot at 11 for 11 last night and 100% on the season. Not a smart play. '85-77, 3 seconds left to go in the third quarter. And Hafford keeps the streak going. Here's shot number 2 of 3 at the line for Hafford. Buries that one.
It's like, yeah, I know he's hit half of his three-pointers tonight as well, but you got to make him earn them a little bit harder than that.
Yeah, Paul's a really difficult – it's tough to guard him because he can score in so many different ways. You think, you know, when you think of Paul with that three-point shot, he's also very crafty down the lane with his little fadeaway as well, and he's a lot more physical than you think also. And then, of course, he'll kill you at the free throw line when he draws the fouls. 3, 2, there it is. Miles misses. So, ladies and gentlemen, at the end of the third quarter here at Hudson's Bay High School, the Salem Capitals lead the Vancouver Volcanoes 88-77. We will be back for the exciting fourth quarter. Get your popcorn ready. It's going to be exciting.
Hi, my name is Jessica Chan, founder of Pop Local. And Pop Local was a concept that came out of the pandemic. When events were shut down, like, we were looking for a way to pivot and continue to support a lot of the small businesses that we did in the event space that we were no longer able to do through a large public gathering in the form of events. For Pop Local, our new storefront here, we currently have just over 80 brands that are represented. We have a lot of products in the pipeline that we're excited to get in. I feel like we are easily will be home to 100 plus in the next couple weeks here. I started on the maker side of things myself. I studied industrial design and used to be at markets myself promoting my own products, and that really grew a love for me connecting with other entrepreneurs and people that are trying to get started in the business world. And I saw how important it was to have your products in front of people and that interaction, and just to grow your brand and your story that way and being able to get that exposure. I mean, I couldn't be more grateful for the community's response on both the small business on the vendor side. I think especially through the pandemic, people are very intentional about shopping local now more than ever to support one another, and to something that we really are mindful about is keeping it hyper local and I guess what I mean by that is all our brands are pretty much within a half an hour radius of us. There's so much creative talent that's right within our neighborhood that we really want to shine light on and support here and to really fuel that local economy.
All right, we are back, ladies and gentlemen. Fourth quarter here from Hudson's Bay High School. This is going to be a long fourth quarter here for both teams. Let's see. See what we got going on here. Price bringing it up here. Miles matched up.
Big fourth quarter to keep their season undefeated for the Volcanoes.
Yeah, with Seattle right on our heels. This also feels like a much win also for Salem as well early in the year.
Yeah, they'd like to fall down to 0-4.
Yeah. Good look at our bench there. Marky Adams, Courtney Anderson, Rashad Coleman. Price of the inbound and Miles matched up. Tough shot there. There's Tyreek Price on the board there. That gives him 6. Miles over to Ford.
13 points. They haven't been able to keep that lead under double digits that often here, though, for the whole game.
Good crossover by Miles. Beautiful to perfection and to draw the and one. -80 right now. Let's see if he gets a chance to get the 3-point play here.
16 points for Thomas Miles.
And he completes it.
I'll bump that up to 17.
Price pushes. Miles matched up. Tolbert ready for the screen. Flips it over there. There's Hafford going to work. Cleveland on Bolton. Tough shot. Ooh, that's a tough call there. Looks like they got Devon with the foul there. That was probably one of those ticky-tack ones I might have let go, but that's why I'm not a referee. Devontae Cleveland, he's been living at that free throw line here in the second half here. And he misses the first.
Finally, that breaks a string of being perfect from the line. He was 8 for 8.
And Tashaun, looks like we got Pickett back in the game here as well. He's got to be smart with these fouls, though. We got to make sure Pickett is smart. We can't let him foul out here. We need him if we're going to win this. Good take by Thomas Miles. Cuts the lead down to 9.
19 points for Thomas Miles.
Thomas Miles having a really solid night. Here comes the replay here. We're going to check that out here. Miles going coast to coast here. Right between Price there. The beautiful finish there. Tolbert misses. Oh, Pickett. Let's see. Where's it going? Is it staying here? All right. Nope. It's going to us. We really got to take advantage of these stops, and we have to make them count.
Well, and this could be the run that we're looking for the Volcanoes. We're looking for them to give us pretty much all game long.
Yep. There goes Pickett. Pickett in the post. Pickett down low. Sean Pickett.
And that's exactly what powered us in the fourth quarter in the last game against the Capitals. We had a really good run, 7 points right in a row with Pickett.
Yeah, it's interesting to see if the Capitals make a couple adjustments because of Pickett being in foul trouble all night. He hasn't been that much of an impact that we would like to be. But you know, if he gets a couple buckets down, there's a great look at Jason Conrad. Classy family, classy organization, nothing but great things to say. But, again, if Pickett makes a couple baskets down here, expect the double team to start coming in a little bit more, sprinkled in for the Capitals. There's Hafford from deep. Banks it in. The bank is usually closed on Sundays, so I don't know what bank he's going through. 94-84. The lead back to double digits. Yep. There's Miles. Misses short on. There's Hafford with the easy board there.
Over to Price. Here's the Marcus was looking for Showtime dunk there. Wide open, Price, one of the Capital Five. There it is, right on cue. Tyreek Price for three. He right now has his season high right now with nine.
9 second three-pointer on the night for Tyreek Price.
No big surprise. I've watched Price light it up all last season. Bolton to match. Misses. That was close. I don't know. That might have been off Preston, but they called it off Golder. That could have went either way. Whitfield back in. He's been in foul trouble tonight as well, but they've had other guys step up, including Tyreek Price and Devontae Cleveland. Hafford from almost half court misses. Right back to Price. Price misses. Bolton with the board. And there goes Bolton. Over to Miles. Over to Pickett. Swings it over. Bolton, you know he wants the three, but I think they're going to try to feed the beast here. Bolton, be ready to shoot, though. Come over. Good cut there by Miles. Can't finish the play, though. That's been the tray all night, but here's Golder. Golder with the basket and the and one. Opportunity. That should get us going a little, hopefully.
And Marcus Golder does have that potential to really give a lava-flowing offensive game here.
Yeah. When Marcus makes a play there, he, like you said, you know, when he's capable of that, just getting the crowd to erupt every time he has the ball when he's driving. When he's driving downhill, it's tough to stop him. Let's see if he can complete the three-point play.
So far, 4 for 4 here in this game for Marcus Golder.
Marcus again, completes the three-point play. Like I said, Marcus only played half a game last season, got injured early in that Seattle game, and then spent the whole offseason preparing for this year. And you can see the difference the way he's played in these first few games. Here's Smith. Oh, they might have got Miles here on the foul on Price. Just not quite there in his position there. Great look at Kevin Johnson. He's talking to Mo Smith over there.
It's like they've had Pickett in here this entire fourth quarter, but haven't really been able to take advantage of it that much.
Yeah, and there's the steal by Pickett. Up to Miles. Up. Transition foul here. I think it's on Price here.
That's one of those smart fouls there for
yep.
the Capitals. That really that
very smart
because that was a good chance for the Volcanoes to not only to cut that lead back down under double digits.
Yeah, we got to move fast. You know, there's a lot of time still left. 8 minutes, 9 seconds. That 10-point lead, though, we need to cut it in half by at least the 5-minute mark. Pickett. Good pass over. Wide open Golder. Beautiful, unselfish play by Pickett to find the wide open Golder for three. Cut it to seven.
Yeah,
we're almost there.
Up to 16.
There's Whitfield. Careful you don't foul. You don't want to foul these guys. Oh, no, Golder is waiting for that dunk. Whoo-hoo, that's a tough call. And here comes Coleman checking back into the game. Great look at our RVN style where we host Media Day. They do an excellent job hosting us and taking care of our franchise. In RVN, we appreciate you. Jameel Tolbert, up the trap. They caught, it looks like they got Miles on the foul. We can't get them in the bonus.
Yeah, Devon Bolton leading this game with 13 points. Real good minutes as he's coming in, Coleman is coming in to replace him.
Yeah, he had great minutes there. He had a really phenomenal third quarter for us as well. Big spark. We talked about that third quarter. Well, he was Mr. Third Quarter tonight. And Tolbert misses the first. Tolbert on the season averages 7.5, 50% from the free throw line. Tolbert's another guy in his second season here for the Capitals. Misses a pair. That's huge.
Yeah, so far they've shut them out of the scoring column tonight.
I don't think I can remember a time where the Capitals have missed a pair all season. Here it comes. Coleman out to Golder. Golder, good step and beautiful move by Golder. Golder's been big so far this fourth quarter. Cuts it down to five, just like I said. It's been a lot earlier than I was expecting, but I will gladly take it. Price for deep, and there's the response. Every time we make a big shot and cut it close, somebody hits a big one. Here's
yeah,
Golder
going. 12 points for the game, 8 points and a half.
Yep. They got many guys who can beat you, but same thing for us. We're a lot deeper. Beautiful, beautiful picking, you know, two-man game there to pick it. 94 to 100 right now. The Capitals with the lead with 6 minutes 45 seconds left to go. Cuts it down to six. Crossover by Hafford. Hafford takes it. Good D by Boogie Ford. Forced the tough shot. Here goes Miles. He's pushing. Good crossover. There it is. Thomas Miles cuts it down to four, ladies and gentlemen. Timeout.
19 points for Thomas Miles off the bench.
Oh, Curtis Hill's loving it. I'm loving it. James is loving it. Bobby P's loving it. The whole house is loving it.
Like I said, Thomas Miles scored so much, he's knocking our State Farm ad down off the scores table down there.
Love to see it. No offense, State Farm, we love you. Shout out again, Bobby P. Media, the man who puts all this together, has done a great job with a lot of great camera work you see under the baskets, a lot of great replays he's thrown in there, stats, you name it, he's been on top of it. IQ, here you are.
Thank you, IQ Credit Union, for providing the Vancouver community with a friendly, personalized service for all of your banking needs. Whether you are planning for your first car or your first home, getting ready for college or retirement, IQ is here to help you at every step of life's journey. See why a local approach gives you a more rewarding path to personalized banking with IQ Credit Union. And the Volcanoes would also like to thank Chris Green, a local State Farm agent who has been serving the Vancouver community since 2011. Chris offers quality insurance products and services such as car, homeowners, life, and renter's insurance. Visit Chris Insures Me for more info. Thank you to Chris Green.
And C-Train. The Volcanoes thank C-Train for providing the citizens of Clark County with safe, reliable, and convenient public transportation throughout Clark County. As Clark County grows, C-Train will be there to provide transportation options that continue to make this a great place to work and live for everyone. Thank you, C-Train.
And we would like to thank Chuck E. Cheese for not only their continued support of your Vancouver Volcanoes, but also support of the youth in our community. Have your next gathering at Chuck E. Cheese in Vancouver and enjoy hours of games, pizza, and more. Thank you, Chuck E. Cheese.
And we are back. Thank you, James. We are back here. We have cut it down to four. We're back in that nail biter. Like I said, ladies and gentlemen, going this fourth quarter, get that popcorn ready because we're in for a great run down the stretch.
I mean, except the Salem Capitals have basically held the lead in this game
the entire way. Yes,
the entire way, and this is as close as they.
The entire game. Yeah, we have not led at all in this game at all, and Salem's had the lead as big as 17 at one point during this game. You know, points in the paint has been huge for us. We've been outscoring them 32-18 tonight. And also, fast break points, we're outscoring them as well, 16-10.
Yeah, it's been really good for them to push the pace here in this fourth quarter.
Domo back in as well for the Capitals. Looks like we got starting fives on both ends here. Mo Smith also checking back in. Oh, what a great move by Boogie Ford to create the turnover. Here comes Miles. Miles actually is the one guy in for Xavier Dupree, excuse me. But Miles has been phenomenal tonight, just like in the Seattle game. What an asset. What a pickup. Kudos to Curtis Hill over there for going out and picking up Thomas Miles.
When you can get up to 21 points here off the bench, but also providing an extra pace of play. I mean, he is definitely looking to push the action whenever he gets that ball in his hands.
Yep, and he saw a good look of our coaching staff over there as well. Here goes Miles. Beautiful move by Miles. to short, but there's Pickett. Pickett there! Yakin with the basket to cut it to two. Beautiful play, Tyshawn Pickett.
Tyshawn Pickett, guys, point total up to 17. And even more importantly, he's also been perfect from the line so far for 3 from 3. And we'll see if there's a Crockett curse coming.
No.
You don't want that.
No.
But when he's perfect from the line, I'm going to let you know.
Tyshawn again from New Jersey. Spent also 2 years at Bradley University. Also was named to the Las Vegas Classic All-Tournament team when he played in that. And he buries the free throw, cuts it to one. 5 minutes, 50 seconds left. Salem's got to be a little nervous here. They didn't expect us to climb back like this, but that's this team this year.
And this would be the third straight fourth quarter comeback for the Volcanoes.
Yes. This shows the tenacity in the fight these guys have. There's another stop. Tough shot. Here comes Miles pushing again. Boogie Ford. Good crossover. Boogie Ford gives us the lead. First lead of the night. Boogie Ford. 101-100.
Just a lot of solid contributions from Elijah Ford, Devon Bolton, Tyshawn Pickett, and Thomas Miles to get the Vancouver's lead for the first lead of the game.
And we finally got an eruption. Beautiful play by Billinger to kind of calm the storm there. He's going to go the line to shoot two. But, man, that beautiful crossover play by Elijah Ford to give us that lead, that was beautiful there.
We'll see here if they can maintain this.
Good as look at Coach Cal there.
Yep, we're sending Billinger to the line. Coach Cal's got to love what he's seen. We've seen him doing little dance moves in our pregame videos. And that's going to get him dancing as we can get this lead back here, 101-100. Another high-scoring game between these two teams.
And Billinger ties it up at 101. Substitution. Looks like X is checking back in. He's coming in for Rashawn Coleman.
And he's 24 points now for Billinger. And surprisingly, that's his first free throw of the evening.
That is very surprising there. And like I said, we're going a little bit bigger today. You know, I think Miles will be running the point. He's doing a really good job pushing it up here in this second half. And he misses. Tie game here. Boogie's got it. Golder's pushing it up. X is down. And we just forced the turnover there. Little bit of sloppy possession there for us. 5 minutes, 5 seconds left to go, ladies and gentlemen. We're all tied up at 101. Billinger bringing it up. Gets the screen by Mo Smith. Good look to Domo Lawrence. Beautiful cut by Domo. Easy basket there, 103-101. Capitals right back with that lead. Thomas Miles, here comes the screen by X. Miles stops it.
I mean, you can see Dupree's itching to make an impact here as he's getting back into some minutes.
Here he goes, pulls up the shot, in and out. Beautiful effort by Golder there. They call a foul or a jump ball? Let's see. Looked like they got a foul here. Big call there. Great effort. That's all on Marcus Golder there. That effort for that rebound there to draw the foul. And there's Pickett talking again. Him and Billinger, they were talking a lot last game as well. Good look at Coach Porter Troop talking to Boogie and Miles there.
Marcus Golder really has just a knack for being in the area where the ball is. I mean, whether he's on the defensive end trying to get that fast break opportunity started or just being in there for rebounds and putbacks.
And Marcus, again, you know, he has been in this organization for 3 years now. He played at Clackamas. He was a Cavalier there. He led the team in points and rebounds. Back-to-back playoff bursts. And he misses the second, rebounded by Mo Smith.
That's his first miss in 6 attempts from the free throw line.
But again, you know, we talked about last game, these free throws, everyone's going to be huge down the stretch here. We got to make them all count. Jay, beautiful, he got the angle there. We got a little lost on defense there. Zay Gentry builds the lead back up to 3. This is going back and forth now here. 105-102, 4 minutes, 2 seconds left to go in the fourth quarter. Here goes Miles. Miles misses, gets his own board. Miles with a putback. Thomas Miles, that man. He is the man off the bench. 104-105. Here comes Billinger. Good take, Miles again. Ooh, he stepped out of bounds. Ooh, that was going to be showtime. 105-104. 3:37 left to go in the fourth quarter.
Miles pushing the action whenever he can, putting a lot of pressure on the Salem Capitals.
Yeah, I can't say enough great things about Thomas Miles right now in this game. Gentry's got the shot clock's down. He's got to take a deep one. Billinger gets a good look, but there's Marcus with the board. This is big. Every possession is going to be huge from here on out.
Chance to take the lead.
Miles for deep. Misses. Ooh. Ooh. Billinger pushing. Here comes Cleveland again. Good look to Domo. Draws the foul. X, we got to make sure we stay on our feet. I know you're looking for that big block. We can't let these guys, though, live at the free throw line. That's where they make us pay. 105-104 here is the patented pose for Domo Lawrence.
Lawrence 14 points, 7 boards here tonight.
And just shows what a warrior he is to come back after, you know, the injury last game. And like I said, you know, he is a great player, but an even greater human being.
Like I said, he hasn't shied away from getting physical on for his part. He's taken a number of shots to that face again, yeah. Testing that face mask.
Yeah, kudos him. And he's probably playing as if he doesn't even realize he's hurt. You know, it's just, that's just who he is.
Well, like, when Pickett throws his elbow up there against that face mask, I'm sure he's feeling it then.
Yeah, that is true. Boogie, pump fake, goes to work. Good look to X. X wasn't anticipating that pass. Timeout here, Vancouver. 2 minutes, 57 seconds left to go in the fourth quarter. Salem hanging on to the lead right now, 106-104.
Yeah, under 3 minutes in this game, about 14 turnovers for the Vancouver Volcanoes. I'm sure they'd like to see that number go down a little bit and then, like I said, take more advantage of the offensive opportunities when they get them.
Yeah, some of these keys down the stretch here is definitely taking care of the basketball. We can't afford turnovers. We can't afford second chance opportunities. Each shot they're attempting, we got to make sure we have a hand in their face. We got to be boxing them out. And then with us, try to, like, if we're going to push it, try to make 2 to 3 passes unless we have somebody open. But we got to really get the best shot on the court here to be able to close this out. Crash the boards. Free throws are going to be huge as well. The Capitals, for the most part throughout the season, has been extremely solid. We've been a little bit better tonight, but anything, you know, that's going to be really important here. I think the key guy down this stretch is a combination of maybe Pickett, Golder, and Miles. You know,
Miles leading the way with 23 points. Golder coming back up strong in the second half to get up to 20 points, and Pickett really getting that 3-point play to open this fourth quarter, pushing his point total to 18.
Yeah, now the other side we got to be really careful with. You know, Billinger's been really solid tonight. He's one guy we got to try to keep the ball out of. You know, Zay Gentry as well. You know, they just got numerous guys as well. There's not really one guy we can really put a finger on who we need to contain. We just not need to stand back and make sure we're on our guy call out all the screens.
One of the big reasons the Volcanoes have got back into this game and cut it down here to only being down 2 points is that they've limited Billinger to only 5 points here in the second half. And then that's been a big key in letting them get back into the flow offensively as well.
Yeah. Let's see if, like last game, if Boogie can potentially create one of those big turnovers like he did last night. And he's got a real knack for the ball. You know, he reads it very well. So let's see how this plays out. Very intense. Looks like we got a spill out there on the court. Is that on the court or is that on the roof? Is that a leak? And say, I'm not going back to my old profession. I used to be a roofer, but I don't feel like going up on that roof and fixing that leak if that's the case.
No, we want rain outside, but we also want to rain some more Vancouver
threes.
Volcanoes
some
points.
Volcano threes. All right, so here's Billinger right here. Boogie Ford matched up on him. I like that matchup here. Cleveland, who's been living at the free throw line tonight. Mo Smith has been big as well. He's knocked down some really big threes for them, and specifically in the first half. There's Billinger again. And one of the Capital Five right there. Big three-pointer, Alan Billinger, to bring the lead up to five. But there's still a lot of time. It's still a two-possession game. This could be a mismatch here. Boogie on Billinger. Yep. What'd they call? There it is, the block. They wanted the charge, but they got the blocking call. So Ford's going to go to the free throw line to shoot a pair here.
Yeah, you got to get your feet more set if you want that that charge call. And it was a Boogie Ford, really good to get those opportunities for the Volcanoes.
Yep. And what's going on here? So Ford on the season so far, averaging 9.7 with 7 rebounds, 2 assists, 83% from the line. And again, you know, he played for the Atlantic City Gambits last year and helped lead them to a 21-3 record, a playoff berth. And while he was there, he averaged 7.2 points a game and 5.6 rebounds, and he knocks down the free throw. So that just must have been a bonus. But that's kind of weird, one free throw. I don't understand what happened there. Seemed like he would have had two. That was a foul, but there's a pick there. Here comes Miles. Takes it, Miles, coast to coast. We are all tied up, baby, with the two-minute warning coming up. Coach Cal likes it.
Nice five-point run there. Boogie Ford with a three-point play leading in.
And I talked about it, him creating those turnovers. He's got a knack for the ball.
That's here so we go. Big coming off the bench.
Open looks, though. Mo had a beautiful look there. He missed it. We got lucky, but we can't leave them that much of a window opening on them shots.
Dupree big with the big rebound there for us, though. Gets 11 rebounds on the game.
Yeah, that, and he's been big the last couple nights for that. There it is. You got to knock that down, X. Knock it down, X. Is that foul? No. I don't understand what happened. The only way that should be their ball is if it was a foul, and I think that's what they called. Okay. They called the foul on Piggott. But I was going to say that was off Mo Smith. But with the foul, that's why it was Salem ball.
I mean, yeah, they're tangled up there a little bit, but that's both of them going for the ball.
Yeah. It's tough. You know, it's especially with minute 25 left to go, you're going to send these guys back to the free throw line again. So Mo Smith, he's got 9 tonight, where he's also been 1-for-1 at the line.
All tied up 109. Pickett has 5 fouls. Be interesting to see what the
his
coaches
average
decide to do, considering the game's so tight and could go into overtime, and they might need him there in that.
That is a really good point there. So it is. You know, I think, well, they might be making that sub because I know Rashawn Coleman's getting ready to come in. Let's see who it's for. Up, it's for Miles. Thomas Miles getting a breather there. So they are going to leave Pickett in there for now. He's just got to be really heads up and smart and can't draw that 6th foul. You know, when Salem has the ball, they're going to try to get him to get that 6th foul and foul out. And Mo Smith knocks down the second. It's a 1-point game. They need to help Coleman out because they're doubling him right now. There's Golder to come back to help. 110, 109, a minute 22 left to go. Still very much anybody's game. Pickett going to work. He gets the double. There's the look right there. Coleman, there it is. Golder, this is it. Oh, good rebound. Beautiful. There's Boogie again. Boogie with another boogie board. Draw the foul to get to the foul line.
Yeah, 15.7 rebounds for Boogie Ford.
Very solid night.
Just really fills up the stat sheet. 3 blocks, 3 steals.
And again, Boogie, right back to the line here. We got to make him count here. We make them both. We get that 1-point lead. And there's the tie.
And you can really tell how his teammates really key on him and give him, he gives them such a spark when he's in the game and just changes.
Energy.
Yeah, it changes a lot of the energy when he's on the court for the Vancouver Redcoats.
Yes, he brings a lot of energy. Great minutes there for X Dupree coming out right now. And we got Miles back in the game, so we're doing that. There it is. Buries them both. 1-point lead for your Volcanoes right now. This is intense. Billinger to Gentry. Oh, there's Golder. Ooh, Golder almost had the big steal. Good cut by Gentry. Miles lost him. And there's Salem back with a 1-point lead. 50 seconds left to go. These teams, that's just what they do. They go back and forth. Coleman to Miles. Good move by Miles with the good help by Smith. Back to Coleman. Coleman deep. Misses. Pickett up tip. Domo, that volleyball experience, tips it over to Gentry. Mo Smith, here's where we need to stop. 25 seconds left to go. Cleveland takes it. Easy bucket there. We might look at a timeout here. Yeah, Salem's got that 3-point lead here. 114, 111, 21.4 seconds left to go. One possession game. Let's see what they draw up in the huddle here. Yeah, are they going to go for the two two-point shot and try to draw the foul, or you go for the three-point shot?
Those are some good options for the Volcano, and we'll see what kind of lineup they put out there, too. Are they going to put a lineup where they can get that three-pointer and then get the press on? I mean, we can see if they can do either of those opportunities.
Yeah, they can try to shorten the game, you know, to try to go for that quick two and then get a quick foul and then get another. You know, they could do that, or they can take this entire clock down and just take that best one shot available, but Salem could also foul also as well to make them shoot two free throws. You know, they could try that as also. So interesting strategy for both teams here down this stretch.
We'll see what kind of gamblers our Volcano coaches are. See what they do behind closed doors when they have their little poker game going.
Yeah.
And we'll see.
Great look at some of our sponsors there. RVN Style. We also had a good look at State Farm right before that. And here we go. What would you recommend here, James? There's Cafe Yum and Pop Local. Would you recommend the two here, or would you kill the clock and go for the three?
I think you try and go for that perimeter. Make them stop you out there on the perimeter.
Okay. Let's see what we do here. Marcus with the inbound to Miles. Over to Ford. Ford takes it in. Looks like the two. There's Pickett. Golder, oh, now you got a foul. Good foul by Miles. Gentry's got it. So they did try to go with the strategy to extend the game. We had two pretty good looks there. They didn't quite fall. But that's kind of been the story of the night. You know, the shots have been right there on the money, and they haven't quite fell.
I mean, it's been a frenetic pace for the Vancouver Volcanoes here in the fourth quarter to get this lead into something manageable at this point. We'll see if they can find a combination that can bring them back.
And Gentry to shoot one of two here. And he knocks down the first one.
Big free throw there.
Gentry knocks down the first. 115, 111. And 116, 111. 9.6 left to go.
His first two free throws, two huge free throws for Gentry. 17 points.
We got to push. Got to hit that. Misses. There's Pickett. Pickett, easy bucket. Now we got a foul. Or create a turnover. So cuts the lead down to 113, 116. So one of the strategies here is we can try to create a turnover here, you know, try to let them get the five-second call to where they can't inbound the ball, create a turnover there. We could maybe try to double up on somebody to knock the ball away to get a turnover, or we can try to foul their worst foul shooter who's on the floor at that time, and hopefully he misses both and be able to maybe get a timeout and, we're all out of timeouts,
or
we're going to have to throw up
a
long three at that point to try to get it to overtime. So we'll see what happens here, how it plays out.
With the Volcanoes' undefeated season hanging in the balance here right now.
Yep, and also, you know, coming into this game, both teams have been coming in, moving in different directions. The Volcanoes came into this game with a three-game winning streak, and the Capitals came in this game with a three-game losing streak, but one of those losses was dated back from last season. All right, so let's see what the see what we do here. Gentry to inbound. And now this group, it's really hard to pick out somebody who's not a great free throw shooter. And that's probably part of the strategy for Kevin Johnson as well, to put all really good free throw shooters out on the court. And that is your final, ladies and gentlemen. The Salem Capitals win 116-113 is your final. We will see everybody for the Great Falls game next Sunday. It was a great back and forth game.
Valiant effort from the Volcanoes to come back here in the second half to cut that lead back from nine and really give them a battle here in the fourth quarter.
Absolutely. All right, so we will see everybody next week here. We were going to speak to a player, but folks, ladies and gentlemen, thank you tonight. It was a pleasure being in the booth. Looking forward to next week. You see all the players high-fiving out there, all the classy moves there. So, James, you know, it was a close one. You know, we battled our way all the way back. They pretty much controlled the game all the way through, and we made the big run in the fourth quarter and the sparks with, like, Devon Bolton in the third quarter, Thomas Miles, Boogie Ford. I mean, I can go name after name, but what did you see out there tonight?
I mean, Thomas Miles coming off the bench, 25 huge points. And the Volcanoes, it just shows they are going to play an exciting brand of basketball from minute one to minute, you know, minute 48. And it's like they've been in, not only been in every game, but they've managed to turn around every deficit into something manageable and something that where maybe in the fourth quarter they can come through. And I'm looking forward to the next game as we are Sunday against Great Falls.
Yeah, absolutely. I believe, you know, this game was just a hiccup and a learning experience. This team still, this is just game four of playing together. You know, the team chemistry is going to continue to build throughout the season here. You know, as we kind of look over the stat sheet here, Miles led the way here with 23 here on our stat sheet. And then Golder had 20, might have had 25, unsure there. And then also Pickett had 18 going all the way through as well. And then for the other side, they were led by Billinger with 24. And Cleveland had 17, possibly 27. So stats are all over the place here, but
I mean, 16 points by Gentry, I mean, like I said, it definitely made a big impact here there in that fourth quarter.
Yep. And two, last shout-out here to Wireless Mike Koreski. We applaud you, our mentor. We look forward to having you back in the booth soon. James, it was a pleasure tonight. Looking forward to our next home game. And Volcanoes fans, stay tuned. We'll see you next time.